Ladies, welcome back to another video. Welcome to a really, really fun video that we've got planned today because we're going to be building an English-style house in the new English-focused park for The Sims 4. We're actually going to be working with a brand today, which is Red Row. So this video is sponsored by Red Row. A big, huge thank you to Red Row for getting involved and sponsoring today's video. I'm actually... There's more to this. I will show you in just a moment's time. But Red Row are a UK-based housing company. They build houses up and down the UK. I actually see a lot of these houses near where we live. And they're really, really cute houses. And they're also like the kind of houses that I feel like are quite doable to build in Sims. So I am excited because in today's video, we're going to be trying to recreate a Red Row house in The Sims 4. And the reason that it's quite cool is because there's actually like a whole vibe going on with this right now. There is a whole competition that Red Row are running, which is called Recreate Red Row. There's a bunch of different categories you can enter based on your age. So you can enter a primary school one, a secondary school one, and an open one for everyone aged 17 plus. And the idea is, and I think this is really cool, you can recreate the houses in Minecraft, Sims, Roblox, or Animal Crossing. Basically, you just recreate Red Row houses in a video game and submit them. And there's a voting panel, a judging panel, of which I am actually on that panel. So how cool is that? So I'm actually going to be judging your guys' houses if you do want to get involved. If you at any point during the stream, if you're on YouTube, I'm going to drop this in the description. But if you're on Twitch, if you do !com, then you can get a link to how to enter. It is UK only, but even if you're not in the UK and you just want to get involved and have a go at building something, you can do. Music's still quite loud. I don't know why the music's still quite loud. It shouldn't be. It might have just been that song. It was a bit too vibey. So yeah, the prizes are really cool. So you can get art vouchers for you and your school. If you're in secondary school, you can get a gaming streaming bundle with a Razer camera, microphone, headphone, keyboard, mouse, headset, and also an experience to work with the team if you would like to as well at Red Row, which, you know, a bit of, very cool, right? A bit of work experience if you were interested. And then if you enter and you're over at the age of 17, you can win a curved gaming monitor. Curved monitors are really, really cool. I used one all the time when I was editing because I like that it wraps around and I can see more directly in front of me. And there's some examples of how to do it on here as well. And yeah, basically today, you've got until Friday the 27th of August, by the way, so you've got all of this month. Today, we are gonna be having a go at recreating them. And what is really cool is if you like search for, like, if you go on Red Row and like have a look at the houses that they do, you can actually get like the floor plans of them all on here as well. So even if you're like not, you know, you're not wanting to specifically enter the competition, if you want to go on the websites and just like use it as a way to get housing inspiration, it's really good for that as well. And you actually get floor plans of all the houses and stuff as well. Exactly, because I've looked on like housing companies in the past and you can never get a floor plan, which these are very country cute houses, aren't they? Very country vibes houses. But they have like specific house names. So these names are the same, like in all different places. And you can then get the house plan of the floor plan of the house. So I've already had a little nosy and I wanted to do like a family house. So this is the house that I'll be building in today. It's called the Highgate 5. It is a 5-bedroom family home. To me, when I look at that, it looks like an English house, which is why I was like, I really want to give this a go, because I feel like when I picture English houses, that is kind of like, I mean, this is a very big, beautiful house, but the brick and the color of the roof and like the gar, I don't know, it just looks English to me. So I thought we would give this a go, and look at this, guys, a floor plan. So I can literally have a go at following this floor plan, and we will try, what is this website called? PMR, if you do !comp, you'll be able to find it. It looks smaller than a 5-bed. In the UK, we don't have so much space. So our houses in the UK, like this in the UK, is, I would say that's a very big house. Like that's a big house. Our houses in the UK don't really compare to American style houses. So, yeah, this is definitely what I would describe as a big house. But yeah, you get all of the floor plans and everything, which if you're a builder, is massive thumbs up. So, yeah, some of the bedrooms in the UK will be like, these are all pretty good sizes. Like, it's got a really nice open kitchen dining, which I love. Honestly, if this was my house, I'd probably knock through on the lounge kitchen, but I really like super open plan because that's what we did with our house. We had a wall between our kitchen and our lounge and we knocked through. But this is a bit more traditional. It's kept separate. You've got a utility. See, that's posh. That is very posh. We've got a utility here as well. Cloakroom, study, and then upstairs, bedroom run as a dressing room and an ensuite, which is awesome. We've got a bathroom, bedroom 2 and 3, and the bedroom 4 and 5, or a media room, this is described as. Maybe we'll do that as a media room. Is that the step? What's this? What's ST stand for? Storage. Oh, it's a storage cupboard. Yeah. And then bedroom 5, and you've got like a landing and shower. So we're gonna go ahead and try and build this. I'm excited to give this a go. Yeah, the ensuite is dead posh. I think the dressing room is posh. And I'm excited to build using like a dream house. Yeah, it is very dream house. As in my dream house that I built in Sims. That was really based on UK houses. So we're gonna have a go at trying to build this in Los Sims Hermanos. So are you guys ready to give this a go? I'm gonna find my buildy save. My buildy save, I think, is... Where is my builders? Is it you? I think it's that one, isn't it? Yeah, we'll go in this one. This house would definitely be extremely expensive. Houses are location, 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 though, aren't they? Okay. And I feel like this house... I feel like this is a suburbs house. So, I feel like this is your town centers. That's probably where you're gonna get, like, more... townhouses, I would say. And this is like your sticks. So that's gonna be farmhouses. I feel like this is a good location for it. So I think I'm gonna build on 2 Oldie Mill Lane. So let's go ahead and check out this lot. Will this feature in Not So Berry? I could add it to a game at some point, definitely. Have you seen my save file, Soph? Have you seen the names of them? The names of them are actually so wild as well. How's the new setup going? We don't have power in that room yet, and there's no lights in there yet, and I haven't ordered my desk yet. So I'm getting there. I am getting there. Lilith Lamar, thank you so much for the 6 months. I caught that actually, didn't I? And Silly Seals, thank you so much for the 9 months, Twitch baby. The Wolfpack Gamers, thank you so much for the 1,300 bits. Dan, thank you so much for the 5 months. High five. Mo, thank you so much for the 1, 2, 3 months. Wait, 9 months. A Twitch baby. And tier 3. Mo, thank you so much for the tier 3 love. And Sunset Simmer for being here for 2 months in a row. Oh yeah, there is a lot of save files. I know. Okay, so this is our lot. It is still, the thing about this park is it's really your rural UK. I mean, shall I check out the town real quick? I'll check out the town real quick, just in case. Because it feels like, I'd have to knock something down. Let me just see what this lot looks like. Sorry, people who built these lots. Sorry. Sunset Simmer, thank you so much for the 2 months. And Yang Sejin, thank you so much for the 9 months. Twitch baby. I'm tempted to do it here, you know. Because that looks like a similar size-ish. It probably is going to be a little bit bigger. Let me just demolish and see if we've got enough room. So let's just bulldoze the whole thing. Goodbye. And let's also bulldoze the color as well. And let's like, the thing is, because I've got the plans, I can literally be like, okay. Oh wow, I don't know why it's cut off the edges for you guys there. What about if I make it bigger? That's so weird. Why has it done that? It's doobie being tricky. Let me see if I can like force it to, yeah, I can. There we go. Okay, so I know that it's 7 by 3. So maybe like 10 squares by 3.5 by 4. So it's like 10 by 7-ish? Yeah, 10 by 7-ish. Okay. Oh, you don't want to be seeing nothing, do you? Let's see if we can fit it on there. So 10 by 4. Actually, why don't I go ahead and do a little poll of you guys and see where you would prefer. Where shall we build? First plot, second town plot. I want to hear what you guys think. There we go. And Luke Java, thank you so much for being here for 11 months in a row. Ashley Faith for the 13 months. And Carly Michael, thank you so much for being here for 4 months in a row, 8 months in total. Killer Bunny, thank you so much for being here for 4 months in a row, 5 months in total. Hop, hop. And for the tier two as well. we don't talk about the Claire Siobhan Shorts channel. Don't be mentioning her. Okay, what did I say? 7 by 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, we can definitely fit that. I may even go a little bit bigger, because one thing I've learned is that these aren't really meters. Yeah, because that's not going to be big enough, is it? Can we have some softer music? We absolutely can do. Let me switch us to our little lo-fi list. There you go. Nice and chill, please. Nice and chill. I hear you. And I missed a light change. Ooh, please let me know what the light change was and I'll get on that. Ingrid Radoy, thank you so much for subscribing. Welcome them to the Peaches, please. And Sam Games in 5 months. High five. The second town plot. Okay, perfect. So what I think I'm going to do instead, Ganglang, I'm going to big brain this. I am going to big brain this because what I'm thinking, I should go buy kitchen counter units because we've got corner here. So that's three in itself. But I might put an extra one at either side because then I've got my utility door, utility, oh jeez. Let's just throw some shapes. Let's throw some shapes and let's just see what we come up with. Okay, I'm not gonna be able to see, no, I will be able to see all the chart actually. I'll put it like this so I can still see the chart, but I can also see the plans. Yeah, exactly. Okay, so the kitchen is 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Is that 7? Yeah. And then I might do it this size instead. Actually, you know what? I think let's stick to it. Let's stick to it and see how it feels. And then utility will go like so. Lounge will be 4 by 3. And then this is the cloakroom. Cloakroom I'm gonna have to do is 2 though. No, because then my study is going to be really small. Now, this is what I'll do. This I'm going to make one bigger. This I'm going to make one bigger. And then this connects here. So it's not a perfect replica, but it's pretty close. It is pretty. Yeah. You're saying it's small. This is a 5-bedroom house in the UK. Like, it's not too small. The thing I have to make sure works, which, you know, you don't have to make sure works if you're in the UK. Just, well, in real life. Not just, it's not UK specific. Is stairs. So, I'm gonna throw in some stairs and just throw some shapes around again. And see if I can get this to work. I wish there was a way for you guys to be able to see what I'm doing at the same time. But I don't know if there is. And this goes back one. So the top floor goes back one. So we've got like a little roof at the front, which I think is pretty cool. Wait, no, we don't. No, we do. We do. Okay. Should I try and make it so you guys can see the plants as well? Let me see if I can do that. Yeah, I think this is a big house as well. I think that the like split between Americans and UK people on this is going to be like really obvious because of the house sizes. It's just so different if you're there we go. It's so different based on where you are. We'll keep the plans on just while we design so you guys can kind of see what I'm aiming for. There we go. Yeah, this is really big for a UK house. Hard agree. Okay, so this, wait a minute. It's all on the same floor. I don't need to do that, do I? This actually does that. I'm thinking this bit downstairs should probably come out one more. Ideally, this would be like this, this would be like this, and this would be like this. Because that's more similar to, like, the original plot, isn't it? What are you guys thinking? I don't know whether to go for, like, a lot of realism. Because those stairs are shorter. Do I go high realism? Or do I just try and get something similar? I'm also thinking... Yeah, this is... That's as low as the floors can go. Yeah. Making it smaller is a good approach. Easier to fill in The Sims. Yeah, I think so too. We'll try to do the exactest possible dimensions. And then... If it doesn't work... It doesn't work. And we'll just switch to... Because a block isn't a meter, and also you can't do half meters in The Sims. Big sag on that front. Okay, so this is your top floor. And... Bedroom one is so nice. Like, it is literally so nice. So we've got... See, this is where I need a half square. That's where I need a half square there. Because that's... Bedroom one is, like, huge. It's so big. And the bathroom is like this, sorry. Bedroom. Dressing room is like similar-ish. And then that's bedroom one. I mean, that's big, right? Light change to my choice. Ah. You guys saying the dining table might not fit. That is actually a really good point. I've had these pink lights on for quite a while. So I'm gonna switch to some yellow lights to match my sunflower on my top. Here we go. Yeah, let's have a check out the dining room. Oh yeah, my dining room table is not gonna fit there. Okay, that's fine, because we'll go, I think to make this work, we're gonna go out one more in most places. I'm just gonna put that out there. Yeah, so that gives us a little bit more here. That bathroom feels like it might work a bit better. Okay, and then from the bedroom, there is a little storage cupboard here. Actually, the storage cupboard's 2x2, and then you've got bedroom 3. Wow. That bedroom's a lot bigger than that one. That ain't bad, is it? It's because this really should be one further back, but I don't know how to fit in the bathroom if I do that. Yeah, those bedrooms should be evenly sized, right? They're more or less the same size. Claire, why haven't you been posting every day? I've actually switched up my uploading schedule a little bit. So my uploading schedule nowadays is every other day. And it's just going to be that way for like the foreseeable future. It's really hard trying to balance renovating a house, planning a wedding, and uploading every day on YouTube. So that is the reason that I'm just kind of like taking a little bit of like sensible head approach. I just can't go over how much I missed you. I feel so much less stressed now. Oh, bless you, my love. I'm glad to make you feel less stressed. Okay. And then on this floor, where is the next floor? Okay, the next floor is here. Where are the stairs to get up? Do they sit directly on top of these stairs? How do I make that work in The Sims? What do you reckon? How do I do that? Where's my keyboard in Korean? Posture check, thank you. Yeah, and streaming too. I think it was kind of like streaming that broke the, you know, the straw that broke the donkey's back or whatever. Is it a donkey in that story? Maybe. Because once I added streaming into the mix, that's when everything became, like, really unsustainable. I don't know how to get these stairs to work. Do we have any smart, sensible head builders in the chat? Camel! That's it. Camel. Not donkey. Where's Taz when you need it? I feel like I've done stairs on top of stairs before, but do they have to go alongside like this? Yeah, we might have to use a ladder. Stairs in real life stack? How do stairs like this work in real life? I think you have to replace them, then remove the area underneath, then move the stairs. Wait, so like this? So like I put those stairs there, and then I put these stairs back. Let me try move objects. You need to remove the bottom. They wrap around in real life. Delete the under. What do you mean by the under? Like this? Okay. We might be in business. Boom. Oh my gosh. Can we get some rounds of applause for yourselves for being clever pookie heads in the chat, please? Clever pookie head alert. Very clever. Okay, thank you guys. And then once we get to the top of these, it sets back a little bit. It probably actually sets back one further, but I can't actually do the stairs as thin as they are in here. So what I will probably do instead is just not do that setback quite as much. I can always make the roof a bit wider if we need to. And then I reckon about this. Now the bedroom does come out one more, but it's not actually gonna work if I try and do that because it's a dormer window. So we won't worry too much about that, and we'll have a go at trying to make a dormer window. Clever pookie heads, exactly. Very, very clever pookie heads in the chat. Let me catch up in some of your messages, by the way. Brooke Bear, thank you so much for the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 100 bits. Some games for the 5 months in a row. Also, Oche the Sims, thank you so much for the 4 months in a row, 6 months in total. Chuffed about that word in ages. Expired Milk for the 7 months in a row. Mrs. Taylor for the 2 months for the resub. Therapy Potato for the 4 months in a row. Kira for the bits, please. Tables are not real for the 13 months. Sia Marie is me. Thank you so much for the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gifted subs. A big heart for you, my love. The Resolver for the 14 months. Thank you so much. And Therapy Potato for the 1, 2, 3 gifted subs. Social Awkwardness for the subscription. Can we welcome Social Awkwardness to the Peaches? A Social Awkward Mess. Relatable name. And also, see, sorry, some more there from you as well. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Can we get some love in the shout for Sia, please, for 10 gifted subs. Southern Cutie Pie for the 12 months. Have some flowers. And at tier 3, thank you so much for the tier 3 love. TARDIS Mania for 2 months in a row. At 550-550-550. Thank you so much for the 7 months. And Magnus Johnson for the 12 months in a row. Thank you guys so, so much. Okay. I think in terms of like what we're aiming for with the house, I feel like we're kind of, I just need to make the front of it look like the front of it now. So let me just skedaddle on over. We'll zoom out a touch so you guys can see it too. This is kind of what we're going for. So we need a little thing. Oh, should I put, are we on foundations? No, it actually sits completely flush to the floor. Let's go ahead and grab ourselves a little post, a little column. Actually, the column's got a bit of brickwork on the bottom, doesn't it? So let's try and see. I'm pretty sure I can replicate that. Yeah, here. Bit of brickwork. It's the wrong color brick. So let's see how I feel about that in 2 minutes time. And we actually have a little roofing. Oh, wait, a little roofing. How am I gonna do this roof if it only slopes on one side? Oh, it's a conundrum. Probably like so. No, that's at an angle. If I like, oh, do I need to do a little room and then delete it? Yeah, let me just attach to this. Yeah, and then we'll delete that. Use the column from Get Famous. Was that, column from Get, that one. Yeah, the post is just really thick though. It's like a thick boy post, you know? Hmm. Yeah, it's a bit too thick, but it might work better. So let's have a little gander at both options and see what we think. Welcome on in, Tina. Welcome back. What I'm kind of thinking is, what will the game say if I do this? Boom. Perfect. And then you're gonna sit under a window, so I actually need you to go that way a little bit. Okay, nice. And then a window will go here. I wish this was a little bit more like a wider hibbly bob, but it's not. It's fine. And then on this bit, wait a minute. Yeah. Is a triangle. Me and roofs, name a worse combo. My brain and roofs, they just cannot come to an understanding and agreement. They don't like each other one bit. Is that right? Wait a minute. It's because this would technically be a half. Yeah, this is the problem, Ganglang. Do you guys see what the problem is? It's the auto-roofing for me. What do you mean? What do you mean with the auto-roofing? Live without a roof. This should be like a half wall. But the problem with half walls is... Wait a minute. I have one more suggestion to throw into the mix. Is it one of these, but with... No, okay. If I do this and stretch you out all the way, can I make you bigger than the house? What about if I make the top floor a bit smaller? See what I mean? Beep, beep. It's whether we want the house to look the same or actually have the same amount of space. Because that's probably the only way you're going to get it to work, isn't it? And then I would just put like... What would I put? How do I connect them? It needs a hat on it. Would it just be that? No, I be at one with the rain. Yeah, I hate roofs in this game. I really hate roofs in this game. Magnus Johnson, thank you so much for the 12 months. And some flowers. And Hannah Kelly for the 200 bits, my love. Let it rain on them. I mean, it's the UK, so that will definitely happen. Can I, like, make this roof connect them all together? I feel like roofs in this game hate English people. How can I connect these little fellas? What's the best way for me to do that? The second roof type. Hibbity hopped. Let me just... move her here for a sec, and I'll move her here, and I'll see if we can use just one roof for the whole thing. Although when I made my Japanese roof, that was like 4 or 5 roofs. That's how I did that one. Yeah, you see what I mean? It's not gonna work. We may have to scrap the top floor, but it would then only be a 3-bed. It'd actually be, if we did that, it'd be really similar to my parents' house. Also, you're way too far forward. You need to settle down, friend. There you go. Wait, you can be a bit more unsettled. Go to here. And then you need to go up here. Keep the top floor. We have to go bald. The upstairs is too big. It is, the issue isn't so much the floor space now, though. If I can just figure out a way to get these two roofs to join, that would actually look the same. Like, it would, wouldn't it? Although it was actually never the right size, lol. Yeah, you'd have to go even smaller. Yeah, you'd have to go that big. But how do I join those two roofs together? Put a roof. Oh my gosh, who said that? Who's the genius in the chat? There's a genius in the chat. But still, how do I make it look? Some genius suggested we add them all together. I might have to do a bit of a hibbity hobbity. Bajobbity. Or I could just actually shrink these down a bit. Roofs, man. Who is it that's good at roofs? Is it James? Put the roofs on the third floor and extend the ends. To extend the ends enough. I have a sandwich situation now. Yeah, roofs in The Sims are tough, man. They are so tough. What about if I just did it like this? Does it look like a big mushroom? Have I built a mushroom instead of a house? I think I've got confused on the brief and I've just built a mushroom. It's not quite the same, is it? It's kind of similar. Yeah, if I add that dormer window, let's see if that kind of makes things look right. This game hates the English folk. That's what I say. Hates us with our little dormer windows and whatnot. Like, there's nothing on here that looks like an English dormer window, is there? Why you gotta be so hateful of English folks? That's probably the closest, but obviously it's bigger than the sun. So we might have to do a bit of this. Ah, she was not bad for a first attempt. You say make one with walls. I say why work harder when you can work smarter? If they were slightly further back, I think we'd have cracked it. You guys say build one. I've never built a dormer window in Sims before. Oh no. That one fell into the void. That's pretty close. That's pretty close. How do I build one? You guys are definitely on the build one height. Okay, I will try build one real quick for you guys. Would I build out of the house like this? Oh. But I've never done this before. But it would look quite nice from the inside as well, right? Oh, return of the clever pookies. You're back. Kind of cute. I can add like roof edges and bits and stuff. Okay, that. I think we've built, what's it called? The Red Row Highgate. It's the Highgate we're building. I think we've got the bones of the Red Row Highgate pretty much there. I'm quite happy with that. What are you guys thinking? I think that ain't half bad. I'm actually looking forward to the competition entries now because I feel like people will be like, people will create some really cool stuff. I've been playing The Sims for like years, but building is still like not my strong suit, but some people are just so talented at it. I'm trying to work out which one of these feels right. I might stick with what we've got, to be honest. Although I do like having a little trim. Little trim. How do I make my tofu? I don't make it myself. I buy tofu and then I press it because I prefer the taste of tofu when it's been pressed and it's kind of, what do you reckon those tiles are? Kind of like that. I like that, like, pressed tofu vibe. Feels a bit harder. What is the competition? If you do exclamation mark, you can check out the competition. It's basically doing something very similar to what I'm doing now, recreating a Red Row house in The Sims to the best of your ability. And is there tiles somewhere, by the way? Rock and stone, is that count as tiles? And then you upload it and enter a competition. So yeah, it's pretty cool. That's a brick, not a tile. Is there a tile? What is tofu? Tofu is a meat sub- it's not actually. It's not a meat substitute at all. It's something that I eat as a vegan. Is there like the little tiles going along? To me, what you're doing is good. I give up on roofs entirely. Yeah, roofs are difficult. I do like Satan. I do like Satan a lot. Is it in siding? Yes, it is. Well done. Return of the Clever Pookies once again. What would I do without you guys? Okay. And now we need our brickwork. Good old red English bricks. There's a specific color that they gotta be or else it's just not gonna be right, you know? It's a little bit pinker than that. I'm really fussy with bricks. I already feel like the bricks are gonna upset me. It's kind of more like this kind of brick, but it doesn't have the edgy bits. Yeah, it's kind of more like this brick, right? Was Ireland okay? Ireland was lovely, and we actually... The gods shined upon us, because I got a day of sunshine. One day. Whenever I go to Ireland, I just never get sunshine. Ireland hates me. Although I am now an Irish citizen, by the way. Can I just put that one up there? Yeah, Ireland really hates me. But I did actually get some sunshine, so that was really cool. Oh, this one matches my column! This one matches the column you guys suggested. Okay, it's got to be this one now. Do I know who the sidemen are? I do know who the sidemen are. I know them to say hello to. And my experience with them has always been very friendly. So, yeah. Okay, I'm gonna try that a bit smaller and then I'm gonna start looking at the windows. I know that this is Claire once again designing the outside of a house before she's even looked at the inside. But I think we just need to all agree that this is how I build houses now and it's not gonna change, so we've just got to accept it. I know that is a Claire criticism. I design houses from the outside in. But you know, everyone needs a thing and that one's mine. I'm gonna see what three of these look like. A bit foolish, but it's probably also the closest. There was a light change. I'm so sorry I missed that. What was the light change to? Could we please have green? Oh, to cheer your mum up. I hope she gets well soon, my love. Let me go ahead and do a light change too. Green, when it finally loads. There we go. Some green lights for your mom. And let me catch up on some things in the chat. TARDIS Mania, thank you so much for being here for 2 months in a row. We've also got Hannah Kelly for the 5 months, Banana Llama for the 13 months. Oh, Hannah, you like that I called your bunny Hannah? It's because the first bunny I found and I was doing Korean, like Hannah, told her to say ne. So yeah, that's where that comes from. But I like that it's Hannah as well. It sounds good as a bunny name. Jack, and thank you so much for the 10 months, double high fives. Georgia Bunnycorn rules. Thank you so much for subscribing. Welcome, George, to the Peaches, please. The Nin Bible. Thank you so much for the 14 months. Tier 2. And a social awkwardness. Thank you so much for gifting a sub. If you're gifted by social awkwardness, make sure you say a big thank you in the chat. Camelton May, thank you so much for the 10 months. Double high fives with your prime. And Makia for the 5 months. A high five for you as well. Can we also welcome Forgetful Mark to the Peaches? If you've just popped in, we are recreating a real-life British house. It is a house by a company called Red Row, who are running a competition where if you build their houses, you can win a bunch of cool... Sorry, I'm trying to like work out what's the best height for these windows. A bunch of cool stuff for yourself or for your schools if you're in school as well. So it is a pretty awesome competition. That needs to go there. And then the door... The door is one thing. You got a first in your Korean exam. Sleepiest bear, that's awesome. Was it the topic? Did you do the topic? I was gonna say I'm saving up. I'm saving up my brain power for the topic. This door, by the way, let me just turn off my shader for a sec. How do I do that? Yeah. This door, I did feel like I did say that the green is too bright. I get what they try to do. There's a color door in the UK that a lot of houses have, but it's not this color. It's more of a pastel green. I still like the door, but it's not, to me, it's not the right color to be an English door. The door I'm gonna take some liberties with, because doors can be any color. It doesn't have to be the same as what we're seeing there. I like a red door and I like a blue door personally. So I'm gonna go for this nice blue door for now and then see how I feel later. Bless you, Georgia. And, oh, should I put my shade back on for you guys? There we go. And let's go ahead and not dream house. I keep doing that. Cottage living. There was like, I want to keep all my windows matchy-matchy. You've got to have matching windows. If your windows don't match, who even are you, you know? Hopefully they'll still be able to get in because I want this to line up. But I do want the door to be priority. It can't. Whatever. Okay. And then above the door, we've got a little dupla window situation. Wonder if I can choose these. Or are they a bit too different? Why don't they have a 3 version of her? Because she's great. She's a beautiful window. But there's no 3 version. What happens if I do this? Sorry, I know this is like so inconsequential. Oh, it's doing a little flicker, but it's a 3 version. I've got to do it to him. I've got to do it to him. They're just cuter. I'm sorry, but they are. Does the house have to be functional? No, I think it's based more on getting it to look as similar to the actual house as possible. At least that's how I would judge it. And what do you know? I am a judge. So I am allowed to say these things. I've done that one wrong again. Feels weird being a judge of things. I was originally going to be a judge, and you know The Sims Sparked. I was going to be a judge for that. But then we got Lexi, and I did not want to leave her. So that's why I didn't do The Sims Sparked, because of Lexi Lubrush. Yeah. I think it's been long enough now that I'm probably allowed to say that. But yeah, that's what I was supposed to be on that. But I can't leave Lexi Lubrush when she's so baby and small. Also, I actually think I would not have dealt with the anxiety-riddled situations on that show very well. Okay. You can live there. You're quite high. No, I think you're fine, actually. You know what? I think I put my windows too low in houses. Because you don't want your windows really low down, do you? Also, another reason Sims hates the UK. Why is there no mantelpieces in this game? Riddle me that. Not mantelpieces. What are those things underneath your windows? Window frames. Are my shaders off? No, it's not. Yeah, there's no mantelpieces in this game. Window ledge, like indoor window ledges. What's all that about? It's a 4 window on the left. It is! Well done. Clever chickens. There's no way for this to look right on both floors. So which floor is the sacrificial lamb? I think it's gonna be the top one. And I'll move these over as well. Okay, that's better. Wide window. There's just a 3 above. Man, these windows are taking me a while. Wait, is that the wrong window? Have I swapped windows? I've gone for the most awkward windows I possibly could, haven't I? The clipping looks weird because of the open bit. It is doing a bit of a jiggle. You guys see it like jiggling a little bit? Also, this lot's weird because there's no point at which the light hits the front of the house, which is a little bit annoying, but I am willing to forgive and forget. This is a 3 as well. This is going to be so awkward. I have to do like some kind of sideways sleuth placement. Trick it into thinking I'm not doing what I'm doing. Okay, how's that looking? Similar? What do you guys think? Just close your eyes. Does the porch roof need to be bigger to cover the column? The column is very big. I have to do it like that. I think that's the wrong roof as well. There we go. And then can I copy a roof edge? No, I can't. Do you have any advice on how to start a Sims channel? Just start recording and figure out what you are gonna keep enjoying doing. Also work out whether you're happy to do Sims for a long time. Because people who watch The Sims don't tend to enjoy watching other stuff so much. So you might find yourself in a stuck playing Sims type situation. Okay, I'm just gonna do a little bit of a move so that we're right like here, so that we can have a back garden and stuff. And that is a terrible movement, so we're just gonna try that again. There you go. Am I gonna do a garage? Oh yeah, the garage. Oh, well done. So the garage, I kind of, not even gonna lie to you folks, I'd sort of forgotten about. I feel like the garage is probably one step back and there's a garden fence there. That is what I would guess. That is usually the way that garage, that's how I feel like it's gotta look. So I'm just gonna do a little guess that that's how it looks. And this roof is actually not at the same angle as the other ones. It's a little bit flatter, like so. Ta-da! And it also has wood paneling on the top of the garage, which is quite cute. I like a bit of wood on a house. I almost just said I like a bit of wood. Glad I didn't, but I did it anyway, so. The wood paneling's a bit smaller. It's more like that. Video status. Oh, the mods haven't updated it because I haven't told them. So that's on me. The video status is pretty obvious on my channel now. Because I do one Not So Berry, one Minecraft, one... country living. So yeah, that's kind of the pattern I follow nowadays, and it's every other day, and I'm gonna be following that pattern for the foreseeable future. So yeah, kind of tempted to use the new path, although it is a bit of an odd color, but it looks kind of pretty. What do you think? Maybe a little purple number. Kind of cute, right? You guys are enjoying the Minecraft series. So the next video, what went out last? Last was Country Living. So that means it's Not So Berry tonight, maybe? And then Minecraft next. Posture check, Isabel, thank you so much. Forgetful Mike, thank you so much for subscribing. And Holly Sims, thank you so much for 10 months in a row. Double high fives to you. Purple Small Owl, thank you so much for the 7 months in a row. And Muddy Adams, thank you so much for 4 months in a row. 6 months in total. Succeed or Crime, thank you so much for 3 months in a row. 6 months in total. Oh, thank you for the hair compliment. I actually have ordered some new hair, but it is brown. And this lighting's annoying me, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. Yuko Kitty, thank you so much for subscribing. Can welcome Yuko to the Peaches, please. Simply Mars for the 14 months in a row at tier 2. We are on a 200 sub train. What is happening right now? Excuse me, hello? What? Wild. The scenes are wild. I'm kind of wondering if I can try and create... You see above the windows, there's like that little brick. Little brick thing. It won't be brick. But I want to try and like have a bit of detailing over the window. Because I think it looks a bit weird not having it. What do you reckon, gang? What do you reckon, gamers? Is it too visible inside? It could be a bit of a feature inside as well, though. Yeah, I think it looks better like that. Am I ever gonna go silver again? So, the new wig that I've ordered is brown with blonde ends. A bit like very OG Claire. I know that that, like, ombre style isn't as in anymore, but, like, do I look fashionable to you? So, actually, I do, because I'm wearing my Feeling Peachy gear. But I liked that hair the most, and I think Ali has good nostalgia about that hair as well. So, I've ordered that. I'm gonna check the new wig cap size, because this one is way too big for my pea head. And then if it works and it looks good, I'm gonna order the silver. I'm just gonna go for it. I think once you find a wig you like, it's like not easy. So once you find one, you just like stick to it like glue. You love the Not So Very Serious from Scotland. Thank you. I'm glad you're still, you guys are still enjoying that. I wasn't sure if people had started to get a bit bored of it, you know? It's always hard to judge that kind of stuff. Yeah, that looks better, right? Just a bit more, like, to it. You know what else I've realized? The windows on the top floor go right to the... I've done them a bit low, haven't I? I don't think this is quite as steep as that either. Not worry. Let's not worry our pretty little heads. How do I feel about Not So Very? I am still enjoying it. I'm not enjoying it as much as when I first started. But I think that's kind of the way when you start a new series, there's like a lot of excitement that's obviously gonna like wane a little bit over time. But I'm not ready to give up on it yet. I would still like to keep playing it. I think I started to do the thing that I'm really guilty of doing when I play a series, is it will get to a point where I stop just having fun playing it and start worrying too much about making, about doing what everybody else asked me to do in the series. And I think Not So Very had started to do that a little bit. So I think if I just focus on playing for myself a little bit more, I will start to enjoy it a little bit more again. Yeah, I'm pretty near the end, so I feel like I can't, like, stop playing now, where, like, that looks way nicer. I'm sorry, but it just does. I don't want to stop playing, because we're, like, you know, we're almost at the finish line. How cutesy shall we go out here? Because we could have, like, a few little bits, like, a little bits of cuteness. I really want to get inside the house, but, I'm kind of stuck outside. I can't really help. Where's outdoor plants? Water decor, no. You haven't watched it since Min. That's fair enough. I think it's tough because a lot of my people that watch my channel really want Sim stuff. And I think a lot of people also though have outgrown Sim stuff. Which is fair enough. Like you don't have to stay into the same thing forever. But it kind of leaves me in a little bit of a tricky position, you know? I do still enjoy The Sims. But I've quite enjoy, like, there's the day where I wake up and I record Minecraft, I'm like, ah, oh, it's quite nice knowing, like, today I'm going to be doing something a bit different. So I get quite excited on those days when I wake up just because, it's something a little bit different and I kind of look forward to that. Also, switching to every other day has helped my mental health out a lot. Like a lot. This is, as you can probably tell, one of my favorite things to do. Just add in all the plants. Add some yellow ones for Grandma Mudge. Just
those in the UK.
Nice! What a beautiful front garden. The neighbors will be jealous. The new video is out! Nice. You can go ahead and watch it now, or you could always wait for, watch it after the stream. Totally up to you guys. I cannot control you. Actually, you know what I think? No, I don't think. Ignore me. I think nothing. Okay, we need the paving for the car. The car, by the way. This car, you're gonna have to drive off this every time you want to leave your house. But yeah. I just need some concrete. That's Salvadorian dirt. But it kind of has the same impact. Yeah, why not? Driving down the steps. How is your lighting so nice and realistic in The Sims? I use a shader called Bright, which definitely helps, but I think this pack has quite nice lighting. I would say so anyway. I think the lighting on this pack is definitely some of the nicer lighting that I've seen in Sims. So I think that helps a lot too. Okay, should we do the kitchen? Because honestly, when it comes to houses, the bit that I get the most excited to do is always the kitchen. And what I'm actually going to have a quick nosy at, Highgate. Can I search Highgate on their website? Because I think there will be... I think there'll be specific kitchens that you buy with the house. Have I missed some stuff? Mods, sorry if I have. Can I like search for a specific? Oh, here we go. Okay. So let's see what kind of kitchens they got. Are any of these Highgates? Oh, look at the Canterbury. The Harrogate! Okay, I'm just gonna look at the Canterbury to see what kind of kitchen it's got. Although, what happens if I just like Google Red Row Highgate? Let me see the kitchen. Look how cute it is. That one's got a really cute door. Oh, look at the hanging basket. That's the flip version, isn't it? That's a flip. Okay, here we go, here we go, here we go. Oh, so I can literally look at how they've done everything. Okay, this is great. This is so good. Where is my kitchen, please? Kitchens, I get the most excited about. I love a nice kitchen. We can only see a bit of it here, but to me, it looks like a cream country style kitchen. Okay, cream country style kitchen. I'm gonna bring this back up again because it literally has like the kitchen dining layout, and we will use that. Let me shift it over so you guys can see a bit more of the game now. There we are. Sorry Moz, did I miss something? I think the shader is linked on my Discord. A posture check and a snack time. Okay, thank you for the posture check. Snack time, I'm gonna hold on to for now because I ate the most stupidly big lunch in the whole world and I actually feel a bit sick. I just ate way too much food. So I will be waiting until I feel a little bit less sick. Okay. I'm actually thinking double doors downstairs to look into your kitchen. Don't know if the original has this, but I just think if you can fit it in, it's nice because then it makes your room feel a little bit more spacious and airy. And I'm gonna just throw some lights in, like, just so we can see what we're working with, you know? Also, has anybody else got this new pack? I noticed that their game is considerably slower because I have. I'm gonna just bang a couple of these in everywhere so you guys can get a bit of an idea. Ping, 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 ping. Ooh, hello plants. You are not welcome. There we go. Okay, so let's go into here. Should I go for like, I think it would have a modern cooker because it's a new house, right? French doors with the glass. I might put, yeah, that's a nice idea. I'll change those and I'll put them going outside as well because these houses do have nice back gardens as well. I'm thinking like this kind of cooker and then country cupboards in a cream. Yeah, maybe like that. How am I gonna fit them all on though? Can I do these little fellas? There we go. How would they know? How would they know? Oh, that's cute, right? Welcome back in. And then, how old school? I honestly, I like old school, but this is a new house. It's gonna have modern interior. Forward, shower. So I think, wow, that was an annoying voice to use. I think we should do the same thing. Wait, does the new Witless Pride, you're meant to match? What are you meant to be matching with? Why do you look completely different? Who are you? Not so sure about that one. Beep. Okay. And then what's that saying? Is that saying dishwasher? Oven? Wait, OVFF. Fridge freezer? And what's OV? Yeah, I might change the upper cabinets. What could OV stand for? Oven. Oh, it's your ovens. Because that's a hob. That's a hob and your oven's there. Okay, I'm not going to do it like that because The Sims doesn't really work like that. It's like a combi. But the fridge is at the end. I am actually... These are quite popular in the UK now. To have like a double... Wait, where's Deli's pack stuff gone? Where is my £20,000 fridge? Guys, all of the stuff from Deli's pack is gone. Okay, well that's upsetting. I love that pack. Is some of my CC not working with the new game? I want my £20,000. Turn. Oh, wow. I'm big noob hours. Big noob. Wait, you know what? Should we keep this in game? Yeah, I think if we keep this in game, then you guys could download it if you wanted to. So maybe we should do that. I am going to struggle to fit in my dining table, aren't I? Huh. Let me try fit in. Can you guys still hear the music okay? Oh, thank you, Pika. Hope you're enjoying the streams too. Let's see if this works. Oh no. Oh no, a conundrum. A conundrum is upon us. It works on a plan. Does not work so well in real life. Let's do the nice doors so you can get... Honestly, they'd probably put like bifolds would be really nice there. But we'll go for like these little fellas instead. And it's got a window at either side, which is very nice. Big long windows by the looks of it, maybe. What's happening? We are recreating a real life house. There is a company, if you do exclamation.comp, you can get the details, but there's basically a housing company in the UK called Red Row, and there is no door that matches these, no window that matches this door, which is really annoying. They are running a competition at the moment called Red Row, Recreate Red Row, sorry. And if you recreate one of the houses on their website and submit it, you can recreate in Sims, in Minecraft, in Animal Crossing, in Roblox, whatever you want. If you do that and submit it, you can win some really cool prizes. So, yeah. I really like these windows, but these doors. But I genuinely can't find anything to go with them. Can I use two smaller windows? What are they from? What pack are you from? Who are you? Beyond these doors. It's from the pack with the knife and fork. Knife and fork pack. Dino. No windows. Well, gang, that's why. Oh, Sims. Never change. Okay, I think what we'll do instead is use the windows as similar as the ones at the front of the house. Because the last thing I want is too many different windows. And there's definitely a window here. There we go. And there's also a window at the side of the utility. Here. A little one. Like this. Boop. And... oh, that cloakroom is actually a bathroom. Okay, I'm gonna give my some of my utility to my bathroom. Let's make it work. There we go. There we go. Can you use CC? I was gonna not use CC. I do have Korean today, yeah. I was gonna not use CC just basically so that you guys could copy it. Sorry, could download it if you wanted to. I think the kitchen's pretty similar, to be honest. I might change the kitchen counter, the top counters though, because I don't know, these ones are kind of ugly. Not a huge fun. It's the color. It should match the wood. So let's see what else they got. Like even, I think they go better and they're not even from this park. Curiosa and Curiosa. Maybe we just put two. Oh, the window. There we go. Oh, they're quite cute as well, though. Oh, I like those ones because they got little storage things underneath. Oh, wait, those are from the park. Have I just flip-flopped? I have just flip-flopped so hard. You know what? It's fine. Curiosa and... oh my gosh, I don't know what it's from. I say it all the time as well. Curiosa and Curiosa. Yeah, what is that from? I don't know what it's from either, but I say it a lot. Alice in Wonderland. Is it? Is it actually? There you go. Now we know. Is there any open doors? Otherwise, I think, I know it is, doesn't have this as an arch, but genuinely, I think this would look so much better as an arch. Otherwise, the house feels quite hemmed in. Like, that just flows now, you know? You thought Willy Wonka? It is Alice in Wonderland. Who says it? Who says it in Alice in Wonderland? Because I don't really know where, like... it's not a movie that I'm, like... it's not really a quotable movie for me. I don't know it that well. Playing it very safe with the colours here. Mini workout! Oh my gosh, that's been a while. That has been a while. Okay, Gangalang. Wicked. Oh, Bean is gone. Oh, she's actually in the corner. Ciao. Doing a little slip. Look at that comfort with a big tripod in front of her. Sorry about that. We're going to do a mini workout. Grab your weights. What should we do? Should we do punches? Punches. Hold them up. Hold them up. You got to protect your face, guard your face, and then pow. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Pew! There you go. Oh, it's the caterpillar and Alice. Bean, I've missed you. The bopple has returned. Little baby boo. We want to create some bean stuff for Feeling Peachy at some point. Like, and like, Lexi, you will be there as well, but like, you know, Bean was here first. Bean is the OG, so... oh, they're a bit... those chairs are a bit tattier than I thought they were going to be. Why have you got a little tattiness on you? Oh, there's a non-tatty version. I think in my red row Highgate, I am going to do 4 chairs. Otherwise, it's just not going to fit. I'm also going to do this. I know it's not quite the same, but I just feel like that is a better solution. And the floors look like a kind of light, beachy sort of wood Very open, very, very light and bright, I would say, is kind of the theme. I'd say maybe even a bit lighter than that. Yeah, it's like that kind of color, right? Yeah. Okay. Right, this kitchen's cute, but it needs some... je ne sais quoi. Some, like, additional stuff. The thing is, they often, in these houses, I think that they do... like, they keep things kind of neutral so that you then add your own pizzazz, you know? They're not gonna, like, do that for you because it's personal. The way you decorate a house is personal. I'm thinking of throwing in a few tiles around here. Just because I feel like tiles are a good idea in a kitchen. Because then if you splash anything, you can just wipe it off. So we'll throw in just a few tiles. I'm tempted to even go a little bit of a colour with them. Wait, what are these tiles? Zen tiles. Not that colour though. Nah, we won't do that. Put some warmer lighting in the kitchen. Let's get some cool lighting in the kitchen. The lighting now is just basic. But let's go for some jazzy lighting. So let's get rid of this. And this. Oh, all the lighting's just coming from the cooker now. Kind of cute. Let's go for some jazzy lighting. What can we throw in there? Taz raided me. Taz! Oh, can we get some Taz-shaped love in the chat? The Taz-ticles are here! Hello, Taz! How are you doing, my love? How was your stream? How are you? I need to have a proper catch-up with you. I have been very AWOL. I'm very sorry about that. I have been super AWOL. I was literally so engrossed. Yeah, I didn't even realize, like, a big Pookie Egypt. But yeah, Taz, I need to have proper catch-up. I've missed your little face sheen. How was your stream with Taz, guys? Did you have fun? Oh, Taz! You're so sweet. Literally so sweet. So lovely. So wonderful. What were you guys doing? I feel like I've not been at my PC in so long that I literally don't know what you're building or what you're doing right now. Are you doing 100 baby challenge on stream? I know you were doing that last time I checked. What are you doing at the moment? So can you tell I can't find a light? Without custom content, I don't really know what game I'm playing. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I like this because it feels modern and I want the house to feel modern. You're doing the 100 baby challenge. You are a braver woman than I am. I am like, nope. Nope. That is one path I will never tread. Because it looks terrifying. But good luck to you. Good luck to you. We are recreating a house based on these plans. So it is a real house. And yeah, it's fun. It's actually quite nice having plans where you've got floor plans to work from. It's kind of a vibe. Babies in general are chaos. They are. Yes, they are. I need to keep telling myself that because I have been bitten by a bit of a baby bug at the moment. Which is just so weird for me because I'm not the kind of person that gets like all like baby-ish. But yeah, I've been bitten by a baby bug. I think it's like you get to a certain age and then it just hits you. And I was like, it will never happen to me. And so about that. You did a wedding in your 100 baby challenge. What? That is commitment to the 100 baby challenge. Fair play to you, Taz. Wow. When I did 100 baby challenge, I did all of it in one episode. That's the only way I could like get through it. Taz with the 15 gifted subs. Can we get some love in the chat for Taz, please? The 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 gifted subs. Taz, you're the spatula. Thank you so much. Please make sure you tag and say thank you to Taz if you were just gifted. I am quite behind on my subs. I will catch up. Itty bitty shmini, thank you so much for subscribing. And Aquarian Momo, thank you so much for being for 6 months in a row. Angie Marie, thank you so much for subscribing as well. And Simply Mars, thank you so much for being for 14 months in a row. And tier two. Yuko Kitty, thank you so much for subscribing. Welcome Yuko Kitty to the peaches, please. And what? You can get Satan short ribs? Seriously, Crow? Wow. Tuxedo Crown, thank you so much for 3 months in a row, 6 months in total. Small Paper Owl, Purple Owl for the 7 months. Maisie Adams for the 4 months in a row, 6 months in total. We've got Brooke Bear, thank you so much for the bits. And then Paige Ruana, thank you so much for 13 months in a row. Elsie for the 3 months in a row. Pixie Dust Buster, thank you so much for the 7 months in a row. Good luck with your final exam. Kiara, thank you so much for 5 months in a row. Have fun. Little Elsa for the 4 months in a row. Jenny Piosi for the 7 months in total, 3 months in a row. Holly Olivia for the 6 months in a row. Curry Keeks for the 5 months in a row. Ha ha. Yuka Kitty VR for the 100 bits. And, oh, I've never got past 4 gens in Not So Very. I'm past 4. I'm on like 6, I think, now. Pina Sims Production, thank you so much for the bits. Dale Scorix, thank you so much for being here for 14 months. Neon Elfish for 10 months in a row. Double high fives and 1 year in total. Have some flowers. And Asta May for the 2 months in a row. Bella Lily for the 14 months. Oh my gosh. Tier 2. Bella, thank you so much. And Outspoken Rhea for the 3 months in a row as well. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. So many beautiful subs. Welcome on in. Welcome on in. Your name is pronounced Elise. Ah, what was I saying? Ellis. Elise, thank you. I'm not very good at like sounding out pronunciations. I'm actually really bad at it. I've always struggled quite a lot with pronunciation. So yeah, if I do ever get it wrong, please just tell me, because I'm not doing it intentionally, I promise. I've just, my reading age at school, like I read a lot of books, but my actual reading age at school was really bad just because of the pronunciation thing. So yeah, if I ever do pronounce anything wrong, just let me know. It's no problem at all. Oh, I need a sink. Should I put, where's the sink? Sink is underneath the window. That actually makes a lot of sense. So I'll put this here. We'll move her over here. Cherry Barbecue Satan. Oh my, and Zest. Oh my gosh, are you a chef? That sounds so yummy. Taz, I was gonna say, Taz, remind me to message you, but that's very unfair. Taz, I will message you, my love. Thank you so much for the raid. Thank you for popping in. My reading age is 11, and it's definitely older than that by quite a few years. Yeah, I remember my my cousin like never read anything. He just didn't read, like, you know, like I feel like it's a bit of a stereotype that I always notice with boys, but they just don't seem to be as interested in reading at school often. But his reading age was like way higher than mine, and I was like, I don't understand it. How can my reading age be so low? And I think it's the sounding out loud thing. I think I just can't do it very well. So yeah, I always have a bad reading age, but I do really like reading. So I like reading. I'm just, I can tell though, when I read, I don't actually take in very much about what I'm reading. That's how I read so fast. Cause like the actual amount of like absorption of the material is so low. It's bad. That was too big. It was annoying me. Never thought to recolor that before, but it looks nicer like that. Hmm. Yeah, I do that, Lauren. Particularly if I'm tired, I read, but my brain isn't like up to speed with what I'm reading. So like I'm reading really far ahead, but I'm not actually taking in like anything. If I'm tired, especially. Yeah, I read the whole of A Court of Thought. No, I did read that. I loved that. I read all of Game of Thrones, and I didn't pick up on the whole Jon Snow's parents thing because I just wasn't paying enough attention when I was reading, which is really stupid. But yeah, that is how I read. Nonsensely. I like this, but I feel like it's a bit too jazzy for this house. I might just have to put in the Old Faithful. Good Old Faithful. I'll put in from the other side. There we go. There's an eye in Clash of Honor Red Rot, I'll have to tell them. It's a very common problem in my life. No one ever gets my name right, I'm afraid. It's fine. It's one of those things that literally happens so much that I just don't. It's because Irish spelt names are quite tricky, I find. So yeah, I don't pay so much attention anymore. I'm finding that maybe I'm overly blending this a bit. I usually go very jazzy on my colors, and I haven't with this one. And I'm kind of regretting it, so I'm gonna just jazz things up a touch. Or at least I like to think I do, but I probably actually don't. But... just even something like that makes it look a little bit more, yeah. Have you watched the Gossip Girl reboot? You know what? I haven't. Is it good? I do intend to. I made Ali watch all of Gossip Girl. I say I made him. You know we loved it. But no, I really want to. English homes are blonde. It's because this house is like a... oh, you can't put that on anything, can you? This house is like, you know, you buy it and then you would choose how to decorate yourself. So it's kind of like the colors that it comes with will be very like safe almost. But you can choose whatever you want to put in it. I'm kind of thinking I might go a bit darker on the appliances. Nah, I'm going to switch it back. But yeah, if you're going to buy a house, they're going to keep it quite like subtle. It's for you to make those painting jobs, you know? It's good if you don't compare it to the OG show, but if you do, it feels a bit tacky slash cringe. To me, it's like, I don't really know how you can redo Gossip Girl. Like, I don't know. I'll give it a go by all means. But like the original is just like such a institution. Like it doesn't need a reboot. Oh, I'm gonna have to jazz it up a little bit. Is it a little bit too boring? Your dad is in Japan for the Olympics. What? That's so cool. I'm very jealous. Have you guys been watching the Olympics? I've been watching them like so much. I love it. I think it's just like an absolute joy to watch people who are really good at sport. Like, it's just so interesting. You've been watching MCC. What's MCC? Minecraft comp? Is that what that means? I kind of want to go a bit jazzy with some like really big artwork. Minecraft Championship. I guessed that. Anything else cool I can put in here? Yeah, I've been watching like the catch up of the Olympics. The problem is the time, isn't it? There's such a huge time difference. So that's what you get in a restaurant, but... you've been enjoying the Minecraft series! I'm so happy to hear that. I've been really enjoying it too. I don't know what to do next, though. Like, because I feel like when people do this, their end intention is definitely to, like, defeat the Ender Dragon, but, like, realistically, am I going to be able to do that? Because I kind of feel like no. So I'm like, I don't really know where I go with the series. Yeah, I don't know what to do. I would love to be able to do it. Where does the washing machines live? What are they under? I want to put a washing machine in. I don't know what they're called. I If you're not in the UK, I don't think you're eligible for the prizes. Just search laundry, okay. I don't think you're eligible for the prizes, but you can still, like, you could still get involved, kind of thing. Here we go, okay. Little laundry room. See, I love a bit of colour. But no, we'll keep things, like, nice and, you know. So anyone could just come in and put their footprint in this house. That's the whole point, right? Bit messy. Little bit of secret mess. Can I fit all of this in? Yeah, nice. Nice. Little laundry room. The laundry room always gets... Exactly, it's behind a door, so you're allowed. That's how it works. Neon Elfish, thank you so much for the 10 months double high five. And also for the 12 months in total. Aston May, thank you for the resub for being here for 2 months in a row. Outspoken Rhea, thank you so much for the 3 months in a row. Mia, thank you so much for the 12 months. Have some flowers. Killer Bunny, thank you so much for the bits. You should try the Minecraft adventure maps. Ooh, those sound fun. And Georgia, thank you so much for the bits. Oh, I'm glad you're enjoying the country living. I've actually made Ali now, so he'll be joining country living soon. I feel like I'm just starting Dreamhouse again, but I'm also definitely low-key not doing that. You guys think I should go to the Nether next in Minecraft? Should I enchant a book first though, so I can cash in my levels? But then I also don't know where to get enchantments from. Oh my god, feels odd. Alicat, thank you so much for the 14 months in a row. And also Telinette, thank you so much for being here for 2 months in a row. Thank you, Tay. Evie, thank you so much for the 14 months in a row. Trinity for the 7 months in a row, 8 months in total. Luke is bored for the 5 months. High five. Ashleykins for the 14 months. And Crispy Tina for the 13 months. Thank you guys so, so much. You're more of a third to fourth gen stan. I think that's when I started to get like into the swing of it a little bit, wasn't it? That's when I started, instead of just playing Sims, to start trying to storytell a little bit. So yeah, that's when, that's probably why people quite like that era. Because I hear a lot of people say that. I know a lot of people do like that era. My more storytelling vibes era. Just doing some little clutters. We do love a bit of clutter. I love a bit of clutter. Yes, in front of there, ready to go in. Perfect. I never add utilities to my houses just because I don't like doing laundry. Oh wow, that is a messy utility, isn't it? I don't like doing laundry, but this one had one already, so it's quite fun to do. Your storytelling is amazing, especially in Disney Princess. I kind of like, with the country living though, I'm quite glad to get back to just, I'm just gonna see what their living rooms look like actually. I'm quite glad to just get into just playing and without a story in mind, just kind of going in and YOLOing. See, this one's set up a little bit differently, isn't it? I wonder if I could... Oh, that's a nice living room. Okay, let's copy this living room. We'll do this one. There you go, guys. After dark streams. The reason I actually stopped doing those is because I was trying to get in a better schedule, but I've had such bad sleep for 2 nights in a row now. So last night, I just couldn't get to sleep until about 3. Night before, I have this thing. I wake up without fail dead on 4:30 a.m. And then it will be like a toss up as to whether I can actually go back to sleep or not. And a lot of the time I just can't. And it's so annoying. But that's what's been happening a lot recently. And that happened 2 nights ago. That was actually the reason there was no stream yesterday. Like, it was a combo of things. I didn't sleep And then when we were in Ireland, the bottom of the garden flooded. The flood got in, the water got into the gates, tripped the electricity in the whole house. We didn't realize because we're in Ireland. Came home, we had electricians ready to start working on the bedroom. And then the electricity was tripped and they couldn't turn it back on because every time they did, the water from the gates would trip the whole house. So yesterday, I was like, okay, back to work, even though I'm really tired and dead. And then there was no electricity and we were just like, oh my gosh. And the gate people came out, but they sent the wrong person. So then we had to wait. And they fixed it today. Or they started to fix it today. They at least made it so it wouldn't trip. It's just really annoying. But yeah, that's how rainy it was while we were gone. You wouldn't have thought, would you? But it was. How should I do this room, gang? What do we reckon? Is Abel still... I'm gonna change the floor in here because it's just a bit too... I want a bit more colour than that. That's better. And then we'll put some fluffy carpets in here. I don't know whether to get rid of the fireplace, genuinely. Because otherwise you're putting the TV there. Or you put that as soon as you come in? Question mark? I don't know. I sleep easier while the sun is rising. Yeah, it's hard being a night owl when society is like set up for morning owls, isn't it? What was I gonna say about Abel? Is Abel still my favorite Sim? I still really love like the memories that I have playing Abel. That was like probably when I was having the most fun playing Sims, right? So yeah. I think I'll always have a soft spot for him because he reminds me of when I was enjoying the game the most. Okay, and then yeah, the walls. I don't know whether to do a bit more jazziness with the walls. Because the walls are all very much like set up for if you moving into the house, you can kind of do your own thing. Although I do like a bit of gray. I'm not going to pretend I don't like a bit of gray. And we'll put some kind of chandelier in here, I think. I thought Abel was overrated. I think I had fun doing his storyline. It was just kind of, you know, silly and fun. And yeah, it was fun. Bit much. There's no really nice lights in this game, I find. None of the lights really do it for me. This one's kind of got a bit of mood light in, and I could put some little wall sconces. Otherwise it's a bit dark, isn't it? You want your living room to be quite bright. This one I'm noticing also does have a window on the side, so I am gonna put a window on the side of mine as well. Maybe two. One, two. A little bit more light in. You missed the OGs. I think people always, it's like anything, you like the Sims that were the popular, or the generation when you first started watching. I think that's like anything. Because I find that with TV shows as well. If I like come in, like the future stuff I never like as much and the past stuff never feels as good. It's like when you were watching is always going to be like your favorite kind of thing. I have no TV in this room. I have no TV in this house. Which is a bit worrying. I mean, you don't need a TV. But it's kind of weird not to have one, right? The problem is where that door is. Salma. So that's Gen 2, right? Strangerville. I really liked Strangerville as well. Had a lot of fun playing that. I liked it because some of the, like, the, I like that they've gone for, like, a story-focused one. I know it doesn't have quite as much replayability, but I thought that was really cool. Sorry, I'm trying to find a chair. I don't know where to put a TV, Gangalang. Most houses don't have TVs when you move into them. True, very true. I want like a circular mirror. There we go. I'm gonna put a lamp on each of them. And it will look dead classy. How did I fix my broken CC chairs? You need to download Sims 4 Studio. And that has a like fixer. And you can run like specific scans for specifically things that are broken. Just be careful because I think that's how I broke my rings in my game. So I think my rings don't work now because basically because I did that. So go easy. Go easy with it. Some nice window curtains. Do they go a bit higher? No, I think that's about right. You watch vlogs to help you sleep at night. Oh, thank you, little Peachy Devil. Have a good rest of day. I can't fall asleep if I can hear something. So I don't know how you do that. Like, if I'm listening to something, I'm not going to fall asleep. I'm just going to sit there and listen to it. Oh, I could do the new sofas. I didn't think about that. Is it a bit mad to put a TV over a fireplace? Will it just set on fire? It does get around our problem quite nicely. I mean, it would be a nightmare to try and watch it. I'm not even gonna lie to you, but could work. You guys have a TV over your fireplace. Okay, it works then. And it doesn't like set on fire. that would be my main concern. But as long as it doesn't do that, then I think that's fine. This is a weird room. Not quite sure on this one. It's a nice place to put it. Okay. Thank you, guys. I feel like we've come to a solution. Change the walls or the floor because they have a purple tint. I think it's the floor that's the issue. If we brighten that up a bit. And then I need something on this back wall because it's really dark in this corner. Hello, Marsh Morris. How are you doing, my love? Need some nice big modern arts, I think. Or a collage. A collage it is. and I'm thinking some kind of wall lighting. Maybe some arty one like this. Okay. It's a little bit rogue. but it kind of works. And then I need a nice rug. You like the room? Okay. I was a bit worried it was ending up a little bit odd, but if you like it, I'm happy. Only problem is I'm not really going to be able to do a table. Unless I shrink it. It's just too close to the fireplace. I would have to instead do like an end table sort of situation. Too much furniture, I'd be thinking. In Dreamhost Decorator, there was a separate hob and oven. But I think what they had was the double oven, and it's fine because I actually wouldn't be able to fit it in anyway. So I don't think it's the end of the world. Oh, Belle, I hope you have a good day, my love. Ooh, can you guys hear that helicopter? Does this come in any groovy colours? What kind of rig should we go for, gang? I always like a bit of blue. I mean, that is definitely a fire hazard now. There is a hype train! Oh my gosh, sorry. That's a good reason for me to catch up on your messages. Sabalina, thank you so much for the 11 months in a row. And Tiger Lily for the 13 months in a row. Taz has been here for 13 months as well. She's so cute. Bok, hello. Thank you so much for the 200 bits. Missed you guys as well. I'm also wearing a Feeling Peachy top. We are twins. Not the crop though, but similar. And also we've got Zombay, thank you so much for the bits, and Christy Blair for the 3 months in a row with your prime. Lanik, thank you so much for the bits as well. Snowy Nika, thank you so much for the 5 months in a row. Half. Candy Mech, thank you so much for being here for 3 months in a row with your prime. And Setrash for the 4 months in a row, 6 months in total. Sabishi Sensei, thank you so much for the bits. I hope your kitty cat is okay. And Sop Gremlin Live, thank you so much for doing it for 2 months in a row. Joey Lehan for the 9 months. Switch baby. Tis Liz LeCorn, thank you so much for the 5 months with your prime. Mia Gracie for the 4 months in a row. Ali Cat for 10 months in a row. Double high fives to you. Emin for the 8 months. Edgun the Gamer for the 100 bits. Oh, thank you for the early birthday plans. We're going to be doing a birthday stream. I'm not 100% sure yet. Ooh, Fluffy Rig from City Living. Okay. Or was it from Snowy Escape? Yeah, we're gonna be doing some kind of birthday stream tomorrow. I've not really decided which one yet, but there's two, isn't there? Yeah, this one could go, but we will do some kind of birthday stream for my 13th birthday. I know you guys thought I was already 13. Turns out I was actually 12. So sorry if that comes as a surprise or shock to you all. But yeah, I was 12, but tomorrow I'll be 13. Wow, I'm so old. Gosh. Gosh, gosh, gosh. Having some carpet related woes. I can't get it red. I'm also thinking, is this color a little bit more classy? What do we reckon? Yeah, the walls are purple. That's the problem. That right there is the problem. We need to go for a cooler wall. Even something like that. Or 13 and a half PV. You're too young to stream. Oh my gosh, don't. I would actually get banned if they believed that, but they wouldn't. Although I did get ID'd in, I was buying a glass of wine with my pizza in Pizza Express. And she was like, have you got any ID? And I was like, what? And I was just so surprised by it. And she's like, do you not have ID on you? And I was like, not for about 10 years, no. And then I had to show her a picture of my passport that I just like keep on my phone, like as a just in case. But I don't carry ID on me. I've not like, if I'm just like going out to like a club or whatever, lol, if I had a social life. But if I was going out for like, you know, specifically for drinks in like London or whatever, I'd bring ID there. But I don't bring ID with me to like Pizza Express. Because you just don't expect to need it, you know? But yeah, this is a cool fire. How have I never seen this before? So yeah, she literally ID'd and she was like really surprised when I didn't like hover. Luckily she accepted my, she accepted my passport picture. She's like, we shouldn't really do this. And I'm like, I'm 31! I was just well shocked, you know? In Germany, you've got to carry ID on you at all times. Really? That's not the case in the UK. I don't... I mean, a lot of people do. I'm just quite lazy. But you don't legally have to have... You don't have to, like, have ID. At least I don't think you do. Jeez, imagine if I've just been doing an illegal this whole time. Yeah, I never, ever carry my ID. I like to be rogue. I love this plan. Honestly, don't get paranormal for the paranormal element because it's not that fun. Get it for the plants. Get it for the furniture. Because on those notes, it's a great park. Forever 12. Wait, Steph's here. Is Steph here? Is Steph in the chat? Oh my gosh, give me a sec. Mods, can we VIP Steph? Steffo Sims. Steph, hi! Oh my gosh, hello! How are you doing, my love? I've not even told the chat my embarrassing story related to you. I've been keeping that one a little secret. Can we, mods, if you can, I've forgotten how to do it because I'm actually the worst Twitch streamer in the whole world. I literally have no idea how to do it. I'm trying to VIP you, Steph, but I don't know how. It says enable. Steph, you're banned from being a VIP. Steph, you're actually banned. I don't know how to do it. Yeah, I don't know how, but hello, Steph. I should be able to do it, but I can't VIP you. Okay, so yeah, let me... So a bunch of people met for Steph's. Oh, slash VIP. Okay, thank you, Mango. Steph. Okay. Yay, they're done. Okay, so Steph, you don't mind me saying that people went out for your birthday and stuff, Steph, do you? I mean, I literally just said it, so. Steph, it was your birthday last week. And you invited me to come out with you to London with a bunch of other people. And I was really excited because I don't get out very much, as you can probably tell by the fact that I'm a loser. And I was like, oh my gosh, so excited. Literally can't wait for this. And I was like getting all ready. I was like organizing a bunch of wedding stuff I could do so that, you know, because London's a bit of a pain for us to get into. So I was like, okay, we'll go and get wedding rings, which we totally did. We'll do Ali's suit fitting, which our initial suit consultation, which we also totally did. And it was all good crack. And then I was like, and I'll get Steph's birthday present while I'm in town. Totally did that as well. And then I got all ready, checked into the hotel, got my little birthday outfit on, put little presents in my little birthday bag, was walking through town, swinging my little birthday bag, being like, yes, check out me, social life. Literally, look at me go. I'm growing as a person. This is major. Well done, Claire. Get to the restaurant. I'm like, hi, I'm here for Steph's birthday. And they're like, well, what? And I'm like, oh, so, you know, it's a party for 15 and Steph. And they were like, yeah, there's no booking. And I'm like, oh, I've probably come to the wrong restaurant because there's like a few of the restaurant that it's at. So I was like, oh, no worry. I'll just stay in the chat and then, you know, I'll let people know I'm running late. And then if they like want to order or like whatever, it's fine. I'll just get there. A little bit later. And what is this ugly mat I'm putting down? And then anyway, message in the chat being like, oh, I think I've gone to the wrong one. I mean, it wasn't as sweet as that. I think there was, yeah. But anyway, I was like, I think I've come to the wrong one. And then I literally got the entire wrong day. So I did not get to meet up with everyone or go out in the wild like a little wild Claire. Instead, I turned to Ali and I'm like, I've got the wrong day. And he's like, baby, because I do this all the time. I literally do this all the time. And so yeah, everybody met up the day after, which was actually the day that everyone was supposed to be meeting. And I did not get to meet anyone or see anyone because I am a complete... Where's my stairs gone? Question mark. Because I'm a complete idiot. So guys, I was so gutted. I was like, finally, I'm get out the house. And nope, it was just another day in the life of... Why is the stairs not working again? Another day in the life of Egypt Claire. Guys, the stairs have forsaken me. So Steph, I hope you had a lovely time. And I'm so sorry I wasn't there. I had all on every intention of being there. But yeah, I'm just so stupid. I'm not very good with dates. Guys, why are my stairs not working again? The deadline for the competition is the 27th of August. You guys should have all taken this photo. What we'll do instead, Steph, is we'll go on a dog walk together. 100%. We'll take the little doggos out and Lexi can bark at your sweet dog for like an hour or whatever. And oh, it's when I shrunk the top floor. Gang, that's what caused it. That's why it's broken. Sorry, let me just do this little fixins. So yes, Seth, maybe again. But actually, no, there's more to this story. So when I was like, I couldn't get there and I was feeling really sad, a bunch of wonderful people going to Steph's birthday were already in town and were like, we'll come and meet up with you and have a drink and catch up anyway. So it wasn't a total write-off. And I got to see, the dogs do need to meet. I saw Jesse, Steph, and Molly, who you guys will know as Stepho Sims, Plumbella, and English Simmer. And before that, Lil Simsy was in town with her husband. No, fiance. Yeah, fiance. So they were like, oh, we can meet with you for a drink beforehand. So I got to see Kayla before as well. And that was so nice. I've never properly had the chance to sit down and had a proper chit chat with Kayla before. It turns out there's loads of weird coincidences between us as a couple and them as a couple. So that was so nice. And they're all so lovely. So yeah, that was the story of me being an idiot. It's a series, actually, that one. A whole series. So Gremlin Live, thank you so much for the resub for being here for 2 months in a row. Mila Gracie, thank you so much for the 4 months in a row. Ali Cat for the 10 months, double high fives. Emin for the 8 months. Erdogan the Gamer, thank you so much for the bits and for the early birthday wishes. Tinkerbella, thank you so much for the 13 months. Therapy Potato for the bits. Silly Seals for the bits as well. Stellara, thank you so much for being here for 6 months in a row with your Prime. Luca, my little crow, thank you so much for the bits. Oh my gosh, I feel, yeah, I'm on the same page as you there, my love. Tuxedo Chrome, thank you so much for the bits. And also a low card for gifting a tier 2 sub to Steph. What? Thank you so much for doing that, Aluka. That's so sweet. Sabishis, thank you so much for the bits as well. And oh, you carry ID in case you get murdered and they'll find out who you are on the body. Wow, that is morbid. And also Roses Are Red, thank you so much for 6 months in a row. And Soapstar, thank you so much for the 1, 2, 3, 4, 500. Bits, thank you so much. Okay, gang-a-lang, so we've got a kitchen, we've got a utility, we've got a living room. Now I'm kind of like, I want to put a little console in the hallway because you know how much I love a console table. I just need somewhere to chuck my keys. If I've got somewhere to chuck my keys, I will be really happy. So let us find a cheese cutter. No, that's not very vegan. Let's find a nice console for this hallway. You are a long boy console. You're not gonna work. You are a whole snowboard. You are, as Goldilocks would say, just right. Yeah, exactly. Steph, did you have a good time that night? Did you go drinking afterwards? Did it get wild? Did I miss out on wildness? I'm gonna put a mirror on the wall as well because I'm so predictable. It fits perfect, doesn't it? It is the Goldilocks of tables. Let's pop you on. Do you go? I don't know if you do, friend. I don't like the mirrors in this game. I have a bit of an issue with the mirrors in this game. I end up just throwing that long one everywhere. You want to move into this home? If I moved into this home, I would paint it a lot. But I'm trying to make a home that is like a home from, when you buy a home, it's obviously going to be, it's going to have like a little bit more of a simplistic design because you've got to make it your own. And that is the inspiration for this house. Yeah, mirrors are difficult. Why does that one not have a pretty version? Like a non-scuffed version? Why is my phone vibrating at me? Oh my gosh, I'm like, oh, I got a text message! Domino's, 2-for-1! Obviously. I am missing my CC plants, gang. Can you tell? There's just not enough plants. I do like these little feathers, though. Can I fit these feathers in somewhere? I'm gonna put them there. Is it a bit weird? Should I put them in that corner instead? Yeah, little feathers. CC withdrawal is hard and it's not talked about enough, okay? It is not talked about enough. It is tough. It is tough. I'm silently suffering with CC withdrawal. I'm gonna put these ones here instead. Oh, thank you so much, Oblivion. Sending you a pineapple pizza. I thought you were sending me a pineapple pizza. I was like, why would you do that? Why'd you hate me when I show you nothing but love? Yeah, I've turned CC off so that if you guys want this house, you can do. It'd actually be quite cool if you do have this house. I'd be interested to know, like, how you decorate it differently. Because this is a very subtle decor, but I feel like you could paint it and go kind of wild with it and put a little fun stuff in it, you know? Okay, and then this room right here, if we go back to our plans, hello, you are the study. So let's get study in this study. I like a study. I like a study with some nice windows and I can look out the window while I'm working. I think that's awful nice. What's my favorite color hair that I've had so far? I really liked gray. I liked as well the ombre when it was my own hair ombre. So not the, not any ombre wig, literally just my own hair. I think because that was the nicest I can remember my hair being in my adult life. So I have like a lot of, just like nice thoughts attached to that hair, I guess. So, yeah, I would answer that one. I might paint the walls in here, but I'm gonna go for this desk because I've never used it before. And it's kind of ivy. I'm not allowed to do the competition because your dad works for Red Row. Ah, that's cool though. It does suck that you can't do the competition, but it is cool that your dad works for them. I'm gonna go a bit pink in here. A little bit pink. Not that pink. Yes. I'm gonna keep the same floor because I feel like they would. When you buy a house, I actually think white is gonna look much nicer though. Pink and white is just such a great combo. What crazy color would I go next? What, like a non-natural? probably the icy white. If I can get it, that will be the next like fun color that I go. Purple wig, Claire. It's like, I like having the fun hair colors, but I don't always like when you go out in public and you get like, people notice your hair a little bit more, I guess. I don't like that so much. Does that have a higher version? Yeah, it does. Yeah, I kind of like being a bit incognito in public. So, colors where you get noticed more, I don't love for that reason. Am I just gonna use this curtain in every single room in the house? No, Claire. You've gotta branch out a little bit. Yeah, I'm quite a blenderinner. Like, I have to, if I've decided to be social, that's one thing. But if socialness is thrust upon me, that is when I'm not as good, like, at socialness. I have to, like, mentally prepare for it, you know? I actually think I'm more introverted than I thought I was. Like, even when my parents came, like, my parents are so chill. Like, they're so easy. But, they were here for, like, 4 days. And, like, on the fourth day, I had to, like, spend a bit of time just, like, mentally on my own. Because I realized I was, like, struggling a little bit. And I'm like, what is going on here? I think they thought I was being rude, but I wasn't trying to be. I just kind of got to a point where I'm like, I just need to, like, mentally reset for a little bit, you know? Yeah, so that was an interesting development about myself. I did not know I had. Big fluffy rug in here, I think. You like seeing the reactions of children when they see your peach hair. That's really cute. I did like having my pink hair, but on like a good day. But if I was having a day where I was like wanting to be a little bit more low-key, that's when I was like a little bit more paranoid about it, you know? This study has gone very off-piste. When do I announce the winner of cottage living? Oh, of the Dreamhouse decor. Soon. Myself or somebody else will DM the person. Because it was on Twitter, right? Was it on Twitter? Yeah, it was. That's how we'll do it. Roses are red. Thank you so much for the 6 months in a row. Anna Banana. Thank you so much for the 11 months in a row. And Megan Marie Dawson for the 7 months. Keithy for the 13 months in a row. Thank you so, so much. Yeah, see, my hair was zero upkeep. Because it was a wig. And if you are wanting to do fun colors with your hair, I would recommend a wig so much because it is honestly so much easier. Like, it's so easy when you've got a wig. It's actually great because you don't ever have to dye it or anything. So yeah, would definitely recommend that. Do these move? Oh. I'm like, why does one feel higher than the other? Does that color go in this room? Yeah, it does definitely. Or does it? Bit of each. There we go. Okay, so we got our little study. All nice and done. Just gonna put a little lampy and some little bits and bobs. I don't know if we'll get this house finished, but I want to get like the bones of it finished, like the important bits and bobs, you know? Oh, I like this little fella. I know you're actually not what I thought you were gonna be. You're so cute. Are you a bit grandma? You're very cute though. Maybe a bit grandma. You're cute. And then a plant, I think, obviously, to finish things off. And I want the little pink plants. You. Perfect. Okay. Study, I just kind of had a bit of fun with, you know? Pink study is a whole vibe. Posture check. Thank you. And okay. I just really want to get my teeth into this master bedroom. because it sounds really cool. So, let me remind you guys of the master. The master bedroom of the Red Row Highgate has a walk-in dressing room and ensuite. It's like all in one. So that is really freaking cool. I am gonna do like a little archy number to get through to the dressing room. Like so. And then a door to get into the bathroom, because we actually have a fully open room. We have a sliding door in ours. But I can understand how it's not for everyone to be able to just walk directly into the bathroom while someone's using the toilet. So let's just temporary light them for now. And I'm going to do a poll for the colors in here. Master bed color. Do we keep things like the rest of the house? Like this kind of like beige neutrals? Do we go blues? Do we go pinks? Do we go green / natural? Or do we go whites? Let me know what you guys think. I'm P. Keithy. Thank you so much for the 13 months. Mini workout. Okay, while you guys are deciding, we will go ahead and do our mini workouts. 3, 2, 1, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. And what was the light change color?
Go, go, go.
Oh, no worries, Kara. Enjoy your, if you're going to Dindins, enjoy your Dindins. I'm not fond of the idea of not having a door between my bedroom and bathroom. Yeah, it's definitely not for everyone. We've got a sliding door. I guess it depends how long you've been in a relationship for as well. If you are living with somebody else, a partner. Like, certain things I would want the door to be changed. To be closed, you know. Green and natural in here. Okay. Okay. And the light change color was blue. So let's do some blue lights first. There we go. Very vibey. Very vibey. And then we've got a green / natural bedroom. Okay. So I think it makes... I think I'm still going to go for a carpet. Just because I think if you were in your bedroom, you want soft carpet under your feet. We literally recently just did this. We never used to have carpet. And then we put carpet in and we were like, oh, well, we did. We had really flat carpets because they were like older and thin. And then we recently put in fluffy carpets. And oh my gosh, it is a massive game changer. They feel so great and so lovely. And I would just really recommend them. Okay, I think the green and natural will come from the decor. I'm just gonna leave it white for now. And then we'll do it with like the decor rather than like the paints, you know? I wish this had better swatches because it's such a nice bed. Nope. Maybe that? I mean, it is green and natural. That was literally the brief, right? There's no carpet in your whole house. Claire, what is your favorite form of potato? It's gotta be mush. It's gotta be a mashed potato every time. I am definitely a mashed potato kind of girl. You either love it or hate it, but no, actually no one hates it. Everyone loves it. I don't like roast potatoes though, which people are always really offended by. I don't like roast potatoes at all. I don't understand why anyone likes them. I think they're lame. So yeah, that's my view. Isbees, thank you so much for subscribing. Can we welcome Isbees who just subscribed with their Prime? You hate mush? What? I didn't think that was even legal. But everyone loves mashed potato. When I was younger, there was this special tomato ketchup, like limited edition. Everyone hates the story, but I love it. And it was green. So I used to mix it in with my mashed potato and make green mashed potatoes. And they were just the best, you know? They were literally the best thing on the, in the world at the time. But they don't make green tomato ketchup anymore. And we're all worse for it, I would say. Regular cauliflower or cauliflower cheese? A regular cauliflower, I would say. I do like cauliflower cheese. Like a vegan one. But I just like cauliflower. Like, on its own. It doesn't need to go off-piste. Broccoli over cucumber. Yes, agree. Nicole, hello! How are you doing, my love? How are you doing? It's been a while, hasn't it? I have been rogue for a while. I'm kind of digging that. I'll have to change the lamps. But that, I feel like that kind of works. Let me just change the lights to like a lampy lamp one. I want like a subtle lamp so as not to like overshadow the cool painting. That's kind of where I'm at right now. Yeah, something like that, but gold. What, there's no gold version? Go for brown. Ooh! Broccoli ain't it! What?! You know you're not telling the truth when you say that. Why would you just lie so passionately? I don't understand. Why would you just lie so passionately like that? Broccoli is the best. Everyone knows it. I need the things that let me hang these. Where do they live? Is it modular? Module. It is. You just lied with full chest. Broccoli is the best. Broccoli is the Abel of the food world. Show me the lie. Where does these clothes keep going? Are they going outside? There we go. Nice. I love broccoli, but not the smell? Broccoli doesn't even smell. What? Oh my gosh, I won't just stand there and listen to this broccoli slander. Why do you do this every time I come on stream? You just like start hating on broccoli? Like, it's just obviously all lies. Broccoli smell, broccoli does not smell. Oh my lord. Absolute disgraceful. Next you would be telling me that cucumber actually has nice taste to it. And we all know that's not true. Oh, thank you, Emma. Carrot gang. Little turtle, thank you so much for the bits. Oh, wow, that sounds like such an interesting job. Oh, that's awesome. Very, very happy for you. And also, Nicole, thank you so much for the 5,000 bits. What? Oh, thank you so, so much. Can we get some big love in the chat for Nicole, please? Nicole, that's so nice. Thank you. Thank you. When you cook it, it smells what? What? Is this the reason you guys don't like broccoli? Because you've been... What kind of rogue broccoli have you guys been buying? Broccoli's not meant to smell. You guys have not been buying broccoli. You thought you were. This explains it. This explains the confusion this whole time. As to why you were like, oh, broccoli's not nice. You weren't even eating broccoli. I don't know what you were eating, but you should probably go to the doctors. You should probably get that checked. Broccoli smells. Never heard such nonsense in all my time. Cucumber, oh my gosh. There, that's a cute little walk-in wardrobe, don't you think? I think so too. I am gonna put paneling in my walk-in wardrobe because I think that's really posh. Oh, hello, my love.
It's me, my knee's back.
It's because it's here. It's because she was in there. The return. Wait, your knees aren't even. Oh, your knees are covered for once. Look at them knees.
It's because they're a bit colder.
How are you?
Good.
I'm building a Red Row house.
What does that mean?
It's a company in the UK, and I'm a judge in their competition to like recreate the houses that they build around the UK.
That's sick.
So this is the house that I chose to build.
Why is there stairs outside?
They're just waiting there.
Is that meant to be there?
It's because, oh yeah, I can get, trust you to notice that straight away.
Well, it's like a giant stair on their driveway.
I know, but it's just give me a sec with it, you know? I need to change this. Because it's not going to be a perfect
Hello, replica. Monkey.
But yeah. And then the house looks like this.
That's it.
Pretty similar, right?
It's pretty much identical.
Yeah. Pretty cool, right?
You do all of that on stream?
Yep.
Oh, done, my love.
So yeah. And I'm following these plans. So we are upstairs now.
Nice.
Pretty cool.
That's so good, girlies, isn't it? Might be so clever.
Did you have your din-dins, Lubrush? Good girl.
Oh, it's even my favorite baby. Come on. Oh, I've never seen someone so cutie.
Ooh, I'm gonna. I know I don't need to do this, but just professionalism, isn't it? Oh, okay, Lex. That seemed a bit unnecessary. Oh, you just found your voice, eh? Is she barking because you're holding Evie?
Yeah, she's barking because you get jealous of Evie, isn't she?
She's always so jealous.
You get jealous of Evie, Evie's doing big waggy tail.
Why are you so jealous, Lexi?
Let's put you back in beddy, come on. Put you back in beddy. Good girl.
Oh, it's Ali, the guy who called me Laura with full chest.
Wait, was it Lauren?
Yeah. Oh, well remembered.
That's my bad.
I might panel this whole thing, guys. Give me a reason not to. I think I'm gonna panel my bedroom. I think I'm gonna panel the bedroom. I might do a feature wall, or I might not. But I think that looks very posh. Very posh. So I'm gonna panel it. These windows are not behaving the way I would like them to. It looks fancy, doesn't it? Yeah, he did just remember, right? I thought it was good memories. Good Ali. He's not always got the best memory, so he should be extra honored. Oh, my favorite curtain does not have a good swatch for this room. Oh, geez, no. What are the curtains? What are these curtains? What are those? Oh, no. Who are these? Which grandma is buying the curtains for this game? Like, that would be cute if it was way shorter. I always have this issue with curtains in this game. I just can't with them. Fully falling out with them. I will serve. I will upload it, my love. Bad Corgi Wolf, thank you so much for the 14 months. At tier 2. Thank you so much. Thank you for the hair compliments as well. Appreciate that. Will these work? Let me see if they've got a swatch that fits this room. It's looking like no, gang. Unless, actually, we could get away with that, couldn't we? Done. I am gonna put some kind of dresser under here, I think. Feels like a nice place for one. Oh, you're gorgeous. Look at you. Wow. I would put this in my house for sure. Gorgeous. The gorgeous dresser. Beautiful. Welcome back in, Honey Drop. And it's Honey Dewdrop, sorry. It's Stimmy time. Thank you so much for the bids. Oh, thank you so much, my love. Welcome back to you as well. Okay, this room's crying out for more plants than it needs. Because you guys did vote. You did vote for a very planty room. So, let's get on it. Too much, Claire. Let's tone it down and start again. I just bought a plant for our new bedroom. I have to show you guys that at some point. It's not finished yet, but when it is, we will do a little show and tell. Because it's looking good in there now. Put plants on the wall. How? How am I going to do that? What about a cool clock? I'd never put clocks on my wall in this game. I've just realized that. We need some nice arts. Oh, we got some nice arts. Claire, if you didn't become an influencer and an icon, what would your career path would be? I don't know if I would ever describe myself as an icon. But I was working for Xbox in the for video games, doing video game stuff. So I'd probably still be doing that. I did enjoy my job there. It wasn't like I was like desperate to leave that job. I just thought, we'll give you this whole YouTube thing a swirl and see where it goes. And it ended up being a good decision. So yeah, I'd still be doing that because like I enjoyed it. I had no problem with that job. It was good crack. I feel like I do this thing where I just pick one color and just go too much on that color. If not, I really wanted to be a vet or a doctor when I was in school, but I did not get the grades because I just thought I would YOLO my way through sixth form. Would not advise you do that, particularly if you found A-levels easy. You're going to go into sixth form being like, well, this will be a doddle. It won't. It turns out it's harder than A-levels and you actually do need to study. That was the mistake that I made. So yeah, don't do that. What was I saying? Oh yeah, so yeah, I would have liked to have done one of those two things. Now, if I actually went back in time, I would try and study abroad. That's what I would do. I would try and like, honestly, I would have liked to have tried to go to uni in like Korea or something. Because then I think one, you experience a completely different culture if you do choose to, you know, go to somewhere with a very different culture. It's a great time in your life to travel. You're like developing a lot as a person. I think it's a really interesting time to travel. And you walk away with it with a foreign language, which is literally worth its weight in gold. Although it weighs nothing, so by that logic, it's worth nothing. But yeah, that's what I would have wanted to have done. You want to be a detective? Fruity, that sounds so freaking cool. That sounds awesome. I have completely started roguing with the colors on this. It was meant to be neutrals throughout the whole house. I don't know whether to tone it down just a notch. Just a little touch. What do we reckon? Is that a bit more palatable? Two very different looks. Wait, I've not put a light in here yet, have I? A pathologist! That sounds so cool. You want to be an astronomer? Oh my gosh, that is a very cool job. Love that. I actually think being an interior designer or an architect would be really interesting as well. Probably because I play this game. I would say that probably has a lot to do with that decision. That light is really cool. I like that a lot. I'm gonna put this in it as well so that it's got double lights. And this light, this room needs a lamp in the corner. It's crying out for a lamp in the corner. Oh, and yeah, the other reason I would want to go abroad to study is because it is definitely the most sensible way to study. You've got really to learn a language, you have to be immersed in the language. And no matter how long I learn Korean for, I'd never be truly... Wait, it's three lamps in a row now. Yeah, it's fine. I'll never be truly fluent because I don't live in Korea. And I'm not surrounded by it constantly, you know? Marine biologist. Oh my gosh, yes, that would have been so cool. Yeah, actually something in conservation. Conservation kind of job would be really cool too. Lizzie Peach, thank you so much for the 6 months of the Prime. Appreciate that so, so much. Thank you. Okay, we actually have the plans for the ensuite. So it has a big old bathroom. A big old bath, sorry. Bath. Oh, this is big. Hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Sounds like Pooh Bear. This is a big old bathroom. I actually don't have a bath big enough to fill that entire area. So I think I'm gonna just like... This is huge. Wow. It's actually got his and her sinks as well, which we love to see. So we'll do some his and her syncs too. Got to look like a bathroom sink, I think. Yeah, like that. Family lawyer doesn't sound boring at all. It sounds really interesting. Zookeeper! Sorry, I say that. It sounds really interesting. Zookeeper, like, instantly find something more interesting. No, it's because I was thinking the other day, like, if I didn't do YouTube, what would I do? And Zookeeper was on that list for me. It was. Put the bath on a platform. Thing is, I hate platforms. I hate them. They scare me. Because why does it do that? Why you gotta do that for? Why'd you delete? Just really annoys me. But there, we've got a little bath platform now. A bath form. Is that a bit much? Yeah, it's way too much. But I think a little bath platform like that looks cute. And then let's get some tiles up. Yeah, the platforms are quite glitchy. Honestly, Detective sounds really cool. I don't know if the show is kind of low-key a bit of propaganda for making you want to join the police force, but after watching 902, no, not 90210, totally different show, Brooklyn Nine-Nine, I was like, this actually looks like a really interesting job. Like, being a police detective, definitely. So, oh, your CC, how have you snuck in? Just use these ones. Yeah, I think being a police detective would be really, really interesting. Yeah, I am excited for Slime Rancher 2. I did see that. I think it looks really cool. I really enjoyed the first one. You know, the weird thing was, before they announced that, I was gonna go back and like do a return to Slime Rancher thing. I booted the game and I was like, oh my gosh, I can't remember anything. I cannot remember a single thing about this game. And I was like, this would be a really hard video to record because I don't really know what I'm doing anymore in this game. So yeah, that was why you never saw the fruits of that labor. Why have you not got as many color swatches? Are you not the same thing? What are you called? Tall Order. Why don't they all have a matching one? It's you. No, it is you. I was using the right one. I wasn't. Oh, but you've got plates in you. That's gonna look so weird. Okay, what are you called? Wait, have I just done... Sorry. It is the right one. It's the lighting. No worries, Sarah. Have a little look. Grab a little... Don't forget to get a little hydrations in there. Do I play Stardew Valley with friends? Yes! I play it with Taz and with Lil, although we haven't played it in a little while. I'm not sure if that's what we'll be playing tomorrow or not. Oh, there's no windows in this bathroom, jeez. Let me know if you guys would like to see it. If you would like to see some Stardew or if you want to see something else. If you would like to see some Stardew, please let me know because I can check and see if the girlies are around and if they want to play it. Taz is not streaming tomorrow. That decides that one then. What's, has Taz got stuff she's got doing tomorrow? She got something going on. Do I have any birthday plans? I'm streaming with you guys in the daytime. And then in the, that looks terrible. And then in the evening, Ali and I are gonna go get some sushi. Cause I love sushi. I actually wanted to get some pho. I think that's how you say it. You know, the pho thing? It looks like it should be pronounced pho, but I think it's pronounced pho. However, we decided to get some sushi instead. The place where we live has the best sushi. Like, the guy is like a god of sushi. So, I'm really excited for that. I'm actually surprised we got a table, to be honest. Vampire Legacy, I actually had to uninstall the Vampire mod because it broke with the most recent update. So, vampires won't be deadly. They won't be able to kill, and children won't be vampires anymore. Which does throw a little bit of a spanner into the works with that one, I'm afraid. I might have to wait for things to be updated. Ooh, very futuristic. You would like to be an actress, Colleen? That sounds very interesting. Very difficult. I'm not very good at doing acting type of things. So it always strikes me as a very difficult career. But very interesting. I think I've got that somewhere else. Okay. Yeah, it sucks that the mod broke things, but what can you do? A lot. I had to remove, like, the video tonight, I talked about the stuff that I realized broke when I went back to play it. But it was a lot. Like, a lot of my mods did break. And I also had an in-game bug as well, which meant that I couldn't write anymore. Which, if you follow my Not So Buried challenge, you'll know that they're writers. Like, they're authors and screenwriters. So that, like, was really not good. Not ideal. Oh, I like those. And what about if we go for a bit of a different color on the platform? I think that's very vibey, very classy, very, very je ne sais quoi. And then is these little platform edges? Yeah. How do we want to play this? Just a big old block, yeah. Can I go darker? No. Too dark now. You've gone too far. You were in the right direction. Ooh. No. Needs to be dark grey. But not that kind of dark grey. Yeah, we'll go for that. Yeah, Fall Guys. I saw that Josh has been playing like a bunch of Fall Guys recently. Because you can do like custom Fall Guys, custom maps and stuff now, I think. It's been so long since I've played that game, so I felt like really out the loop. I didn't realize there was like all this extra stuff you can do now. Stacy, hello! Look up a game called Stray, a platform puzzle adventure where you play as a cat! And also you're on a break. I hope work's going okay, my love. Melly D, thank you so much for the 6 months in a row with your Prime. And Isator, thank you so much for the 3 months. Jordan Ma, thank you so much for the bits. Oh, you got a gift from Taz. A Current Direction, thank you so much for the 7 months in a row. Mo Klansky, thank you so much for the 6 months in a row. And Paperback Simmer, thank you so much for the 8 months. Also, Lizzie Peach, did I catch your 6 months? I think I did, but if not, thank you. Okay, this is a nice little master bed to bathroom situation, if I do say so myself. This room's cute. Should I put some little pictures up? Do you put pictures up in the bathroom though? Or are they just gonna get all soggy? Like, I feel like there is a high potential for them to get a bit soggy. But we'll pop one up just for aesthetic vibes, you know? And then I might put a little rugging down in here. But what kind? Do you just put a rug in the middle of your bathroom? You'd probably put more like a bath mat, wouldn't you? Little bath mats. That's the most redundant bath mat I've ever seen in all of my time. Okay. That's nice. I like that a lot. I think like these rooms are really easy to decorate because it's all been like so sensibly designed. And I think you do tend to get that on these kinds of houses. Like, oh, how are you meant to get into that room? I think I'm gonna get rid of the storage. sitch, because you're not going to be able to get in, are you? Yeah, these kind of houses tend to have, like, they're laid out smartly, just because they've been, like, you know, it's a house that has been built by a company that knows that this works, so they just keep, like, the same structure, and then it's nice and easy for you to, like, decorate when it's your house, because it's proven, you know? I want a blue bedroom, so I'm going to do a blue bedroom now, because I really like a blue bedroom. I just like them. I just find them dead vibey. So let's pop a little source of light in this room. And let's get to our blue bedroom. And I kind of might make this like a... If I can fit like a little desk in there, I might do. But I do want to do a double bed, so I might not. Oh no, I think we might be able to. No, we're not going to be able to. Okay. Wait, I could do the bed in the corner. Like a teenage boy room. Like that kind of... situation. That bed is weird, man. I don't like that. Not very... Oh, that's quite teenage boy. There we go. We've been live for 3 hours. I just came back and I was like, yes, I will do a long stream. A little bit of blue. Oh no, it's a bit of clash in blue. I love blue bedrooms. Princessy blue ones. See, I was thinking more teenage boy blue. Like, I was thinking like, oh geez, hello. More like my brother kind of room. Just because I had a brother that always had a blue room. Actually, he had a Leeds United room for a while. Literally Leeds United wallpaper. Or actually, if you've watched my making my childhood home, I actually got quite emotional making that. I think I talked about Dane's Leeds United wallpaper. You love Leeds that much, you have to decorate your whole room as Leeds. It's 6:45! Ah! We're almost done. Tyre Tansy, thank you so much for the 14 months. Thank you for the welcome back. And Frisky Wren, thank you so much for the cheer there. Thank you so much for the bits. I'm going to put one of these. I don't know what's at the back of the house. Oh, yeah, it's what I thought. There is a window. Nice. And there's also... Yeah, we've got that window there. I've actually made up this window, though, because this doesn't actually exist. But I'm going to keep it there because I think it's nice. Imagine having a double bed as a teenager. I had a double bed as a teenager. My room was awkwardly shaped, so it was like, where the bed was, you couldn't get in at either side. You like, had a little slither to get down. But it's because I fell out of my bunk bed, and when I broke my wrist, my new bed, they just got... No, actually, I had a single for a while, and then they put me in a double. So yeah, I did have one. Ali's room was really tiny when he was at home as well. It's actually the room where you can see him. His initial recordings are in there too. I don't like this bed. I'm sorry. I'm going to get rid of the bed. It was like his house is old. And his parents' house is old. So it had like a little sink in the corner as well. Wow. Please just give me a nice blue bed. I didn't think I was asking for a lot, but apparently I really was. Yes, a tartan bed, hello. Double beds are superior. Ali and I's bed now, because Ali is so tall, is a super king. So it's huge. And if we don't sleep diagonal, his feet still go off the edge. Tall person problems. Right there. We have to sleep at a bit of a diagonal like that. Tall boy. He is tall boy. Tall boy Ali. With these long leggies. And I hate when your foot goes out the edge of the bed. Because obviously... the monsters will take it for themselves. So you've got to be careful. I struggle so much with curtains in this game. How much of my streams, literally, I spent trying to find curtains? I feel like it's quite high. It's higher than it needs to be. Let's just put it that way. I just can't find a good... Like, why is that that color? Why is it not like a deep, beautiful blue? Why is it like this scratchy blue? And who is that? How tall is Ali? Ali is 6'3". So he's not even like ungodly tall, you know? But he's tall enough that beds can be annoying. They're cool. I just feel like white curtains are just not gonna work in this room, you know? So close to enabling CC just for this bedroom. Why you've got cat on it? Do these curtains exist without the cat? Is there like a plain version? Please tell me they gave us those curtains without a cat on them. Oh, I'm getting my skates on. Don't worry, Gangalang. I just really want to finish. I wanted to finish these two bedrooms. But I just can't. Why have they got Halloween curtains, but no normal curtains? What? Who decided that? I'm just going to put that one on and be done with it. Like, oh, I'm annoyed. That has wound me right up, I tell you. That has really ground my gears. Do boys have a mirror? A boy would have a mirror in his room. Yeah. And then I just need some, like, clutter. Like, kids... Boys' room clutter. Yeah, like... this like coming out from under the bed and stuff, and that's maybe a bit young, but boy room clutter please. Mum's brought him some drink. Will I consider continuing playing Mass Effect? Wow, that was a struggle to get out, wasn't it? I do want to, but I'm not sure how much people were enjoying it. That was my my issue, yeah. Yes. Generic boy room clutter number 4. Some shirts that he should be putting in his wardrobe, but he's left there. Actually, no. You know what happened? His mom was like, put your shirts away, and they just sat on the end of the bed, getting all creased. A bowling ball. Everyone just seems to have one of those. His little backpack for school. Yeah. 10 minutes! Okay, I'm getting my skates on. I promise. There we go. Okay. I think that has quite good boy room vibes. Boys room. The floor plan for Red Row Houses, if you go comp, you will get the details for the Red Room. No, it's not The Shining. The Red Row competition that I am actually I'm one of the judges of. So if you wanted to get involved, I will be judging. You can go to the website, you can see all of the different houses, and also you'll be able to find floor plans. That's what I use to get the floor plans. So yeah, it's good. Even it, like, I would definitely encourage you guys to enter the competition. But even if you don't, if you're not in the UK, I think it's a really good site to see floor plans to try and have a go at making in Sims. So yeah. Hometown's gonna say that. And then I was kind of wanting to do a bit more of a... What about a room for two kids that are sharing a bedroom together? But don't want a bunk bed. But maybe they do want a bunk bed. Yeah, they want a bunk bed. They changed their mind. I like this one. This doesn't exist as a bunk bed. Get rid of you. There you go. Yes, two bunk beds. Even though you made me break my wrist. And I can share a desk. Would I ever consider building my in real life house in Sims? I did. I did build my in real life house in Sims. I did it about a year ago, maybe a little bit more. And then I actually updated it when we did the extension. I actually used that to help, like, we used it to kind of figure out what we wanted to do. So yeah, you can see that on my YouTube channel. And see how we went from that to, like, actually the extension that we did end up building on our house. We should do a movie hangout on Switch. Yeah, because some movies you can play on Switch. The thing is, I'd worry that if I'm watching a movie, I'd get like really into it and then like just kind of zone out a little bit. And I don't know. I might like do something embarrassing, like pick my nose or something, you know? That would be embarrassing. I can see it happening. I can see it clear as day. You come in a little pink. Ooh, you're a bit much in pink. There you go. And we did manage to get to the top floor, but it was a lot to try and get through. I think we've done a pretty good job. I think we've had a good crack at it. What about some wallpaper? We've not done any wallpaper in this house yet. That's kind of pretty. Is that a bit much? I think it's quite pretty. Oh, thank you, Ava Bunny. Have a nice rest of day, my love. We will be finishing the stream shortly as well, because I've got my lesson this evening. So, yeah. Ali forgot and he was like, do you want to play badminton? And I'm like, babe, I can't. I got my lesson. This room is cute. I would very happily have this room. Are there not so berry houses on the gallery? The original house, yes. The one that Clem lived in as a child, yes. Which other houses did we have? Oh, I don't think Saffron's house is actually. Did I ever upload Saffron's house? I kind of don't feel as though I did. No, I don't think I did that one. I should do it. Because that one is like one of my faves as well. Wait, I'll put you on here. I'll put you on here. And then back to clutter. Just meant to look like a kid's room. Maybe I'm in my head, I'm kind of designing it, imagining that there's two girls. Probably not that old though. A bit younger than that. No makeup yet. But apparently perfume's fine. Yeah. And that's a cute room. And then I just want to finish the hallway because I don't like unfinished hallways. 4 minutes! I'm getting my little skates on, gang. I feel like on these kind of houses, they always put carpets in the upstairs halls. No other room I didn't get time to do. I didn't get time to do the upstairs bathroom, which is such. But yeah, let's finish off this hallway a little bit. And is there any lights here right now? There we go. And we'll put some little curtains on here. Scarlet's house? No. The White House. Scarlet lived in the White House. Did I ever put the White House on the gallery? I kind of don't feel like I did, you know? Yeah, I don't think I did. No, I don't think I put the White House on. I have to put that on because I do be loving the White House. There's no room to put anything else in this hallway. Maybe a picture on the wall, but that's kind of it. But yeah, that was a cool house as well. That one I think that was the first build, like full house build, that I did completely on stream. So yeah, that was fun. Took us quite a long time as well. Honestly, builds take me ages. I'm quite like decisive about the things that I want, so they often take me quite a long time. And yeah. Oh, I wanted to do more of the garden because, okay, let me just tell you what my vision for the garden was. I noticed on the website that the gardens are often have walls around them. So I was gonna do... This is the wrong color, really. None of these quite the right color. But I was gonna like wall in the garden because I thought that would be kind of cool. This is like bamboo. It's not really... what I wanted. Neither is that. Of course they don't have what I want. But yeah, I was gonna do like a little garden out back and then have like a little path along the side of the house there. And then I was gonna put like the little bins at the front. And then maybe I'd put a little bit here. And then there'd be like, this bit would have like a little fence because I thought that would be kind of cute. And then maybe it would come to there. And but does it need all that? I don't think it need. I think it's better being open at the front. And then I wanted to put like a little tree maybe on the outside of the lot, just so that there's like a little, not that, just so it's kind of feeling like they've planted a few trees when they were like doing the neighborhood, because it's nice to have that kind of stuff, isn't it? Not bamboo though, because that is not very native to the UK. These kinds of trees are though. Yeah, a few little trees, just so it's feeling all like at home in nature and whatnot. And I thought that would be kind of cute. And okay, I will... just give me one sec, give me one sec, give me one sec. I just want to put like some little bushings at the front here. Because I don't like it when things don't look finished. So let's just put like a few little grasses and whatnot. Make it look all nice. No, not that one, that one's too spiky. Make it feel all nice and finished. I have standards with my builds that I've got to try and maintain at all times, you know? Yeah. Oh, wait, one last thing. Sorry. I want like a little light over my door, my porch, so that when I go at nighttime, I feel safe. And I want it to be a little bit like goldy, but not like that. No, not like any of those. Okay. And I think we're done with our little housey. So we see how it looks on a nighttime. So homey. Literally so homey. I'm 2 minutes late. Okay, it's fine. It's fine. It's fine. So guys, that is my Red Row remake. If you guys want to get involved, now is your chance. Please do !! Comp. And go ahead, check out everything you need to do to recreate your own Red Row. If you're in the UK, I seriously encourage you guys to get involved in this because it's really good experience in terms of building. There are some awesome prizes up for grabs as well. And I just think it's really nice when brands realize there's cool ways that you can like do stuff with games. Like this is so fun to be able to do. And get the floor plans and literally make the house the exact same way it is on the website. I just genuinely think that's like a really cool, like nice feature. So yeah, I would 100% encourage you guys to give it a go. I will pop it on the screen again. No, I won't because I clicked the wrong thing. Chrome, go on babes. Fit to screen. There you go. It's gone really big, but there we go. Why are you being so big for, babes? Go a bit more. Fit to screen. No, you've been annoying. It's been a bit annoying. There we go. It's having none of it. There we go. Design our homes with Red Row. So yeah, I encourage you guys to get involved in the Red Row recreate because I had a lot of fun doing that house. You can get the floor plans on there and you can have a go at designing are recreating the houses that are on the website. There is a bunch of different ones. I picked a very big one, but they also have like smaller cottagey builds. They have like houses together and three beds, four beds, whatever you guys want to give a go. They have a load of options on there. So I encourage you guys to give it a go. And thank you guys so, so much for hanging out with me today. We'll be going to be doing birthday stream tomorrow. So make sure you guys stick around for that. H Blueness, thank you so, so much for the bids. TB, thank you so much for the 11 months. Ulti Wulti, thank you so much for the 9 months. A Twitch baby. Savishi, thank you so, so much for the bits. And I'm glad you like that about Not So Very. Reem, thank you so much for the 12 months. Have some flowers. And Sweet Val for the 6 months in a row. And Sunflower for the 6 months. Thank you so much to everyone that resubbed today. And continue to support me, even though I know I've not been streaming at quite as much recently. I had so much fun with you guys today. And I will see you tomorrow for my birthday stream. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye.